Lord, we declare the things that are not as though they were. By faith, we declare the things that are not as though they were. The person that came in sick, we declare that they leave healed here tonight. The person that came in heartbroken leaves restored here tonight. Oh, estamos declarando las cosas que no son como si fuesen por la fe. Oh, Señor, aquel que vino enfermo saldrá sano. Aquel que vino con el corazón dolido sale restaurado. Aquel que ha regresado, Señor, de un caminar inmundo saldrá, Señor, arrepentido. Come on, come on, come on, vamos, vamos. Y oro vos y arabacayara. Vamos, yo siento algo que se está moviendo. I feel something that is breaking loose. Algo se está rompiendo. I hear the chains falling. Se escuchan las cadenas caer. Come on. You gotta believe it in faith. You gotta see it already. You gotta see your victory. Tienes que ver tu victoria. Tienes que ver ya tu triunfo. En el nombre de Jesús. Vamos, vamos. Oh, you gotta shout a victory shout. You gotta praise a victory praise. Tienes que gritar un grito de victoria. Tienes que alabar como una alabanza de triunfo. Vamos, vamos. Se siente el poder de Dios aquí. The power of God is being felt in this place. Vamos, 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 pueblo. Come on, come on. If you've got the gift of tongues, speak in tongues. Si tienes el don de lenguas, habla en lenguas. Vamos. Come on. Come on, let heaven connect with the earth right now. Que el cielo se conecte con la tierra ahora. You are the conduit. You are the channel. You are the way that it's going to happen. Tú eres el conducto. Tú eres ese canal por el cual el cielo se va a conectar con la tierra. Oh, the miraculous is here. Lo milagroso está aquí. The supernatural glory of God is in this place. La gloria sobrenatural está en este lugar. Vamos, vamos. No te canses, no te canses, no te canses. Come on, don't get tired, don't get tired. Come on, let's give them our all. Vamos a darle todo. Vamos a darle todo al Señor. Y oramos y arabaca. Oh, reprendemos toda obra del diablo en el nombre de Jesús. Diablo, esta es casa de Dios y puerta al cielo. Lord, we rebuke every work of the devil in the name of Jesus. Devil, let it be known that this is the house of God and the gateway to heaven in the name of Jesus. Lord, manifest, God. Send your angels to war. Envía tus ángeles a guerrear por nosotros y con nosotros, Señor, en el nombre de Jesús. Let heaven invade the earth. Let heaven invade this place. Que el cielo invada este lugar, Señor. Exáltale, exáltale, exáltale. Come on. Come on, come on. Exalt him, exalt him, exalt him. Don't get tired, don't grow weary. Come on, come on. Vamos, no te canses. No te canses. Adora, 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 adora. Alaba, exalta, 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 exalta. Oh, the Lord is here, the Lord is here. El Señor está aquí. Shande yorobo si alabaca. Oh, Lord, have your way tonight, Lord. Let your anointing fall upon every musician, every singer, Lord God, every speaker, every participant, Lord. Let your anointing fall, Lord Jesus. Hide us behind the cross, Lord God, and let it be you. Let it be you. Let it be you that moves. Let it be you that ministers. Let it be you that flows, Lord God. Unge cada músico, unge, Señor, cada cantante. Come on, for the next 10 seconds, let's give a shout. Come on, por los próximos 10 segundos, dale un grito. Dale alabanza. Give them praise. Come on, come on, come on. We can do better. Vamos, vamos. Dale gloria. Dale alabanza. Digno es el Señor.
Darkness, a substance of nothing, yet it fills the lost one's heart. We all had darkness. We were all a ruined piece of art. You see, we all ran aimlessly, death leading us through the night, not knowing where to turn. We moved with no end in our sight. Oh, but if it weren't for him, he who was the light, for behold the light of the world, that saved me from my own demise. For his stripes gave us life, and by his light, we arise.
Praise the Lord, National Youth Convention. Somebody lift up a shout of praise in this house. Is there anyone that wants the glory of God to break out in this place? Put your hands together as we magnify the name that is above every name. Say we feel
a mighty rushing wind.
We see. wonder if there's anyone that has a need for the Holy Ghost. Anyone that has a need for a move of God. Habrá alguien que tenga necesidad por un mover de Dios en este lugar. No se quede callado. Don't stay quiet. If you need a move, open up your mouth. Throw your head back and lift up a shout.
God!
victorioso en este lugar. Mira, si ustedes han venido muy emocionales, listos nomás para brincar y hacer ruido, está bien. Pero yo quisiera saber si en esta casa hay alguien que pueda decir que si no fuera vivo por el Señor Jesucristo, alguien que debería de haber estado en la cárcel, alguien que debería de haber estado en el hospital, alguien que aún debería de estar muerto, pero Dios en su misericordia, Él te halló, te sacó del lodo cenagoso. Y ahora puedes declarar: yo soy victorioso. El diablo me trató de atrapar, pero yo soy victorioso. Coronavirus me trató de atrapar, pero yo soy victorioso. ¿Habrá alguien que tiene victoria en esta noche? Declaremos: celebra victorioso.
Celebra victorioso.
El triunfo de Cristo.
El triunfo de Cristo.
Muchas formas de alabar su nombre y de exaltarte, oh Jehová. Hay muchas formas de magnificarle, pero ahora yo haré así. Saco mi vida del anonimato, medio corona y vestido real. Así es Jehová que exalta al pequeño, por causa de él yo haré más mil. Celebrando su poder con alegría en el corazón, como el que va con la flauta al monte de Jehová, celebraremos su poder.
Él es el poderoso de Israel,
el poderoso de Israel.
Su voz se oirá, nadie lo detendrá.
Al poderoso de Israel,
Él es el poderoso de Israel,
Él es el poderoso,
el poderoso de Israel.
Se abrirán, de ellos verán. Los oídos de los sordos oirán. El cojo saltará, con el arpa danzará. La lengua de los mudos cantará.
Él es el poderoso de Israel,
el poderoso de Israel.
Su voz se oirá, nadie lo detendrá.
Al poderoso de Israel,
Él es el poderoso de Israel,
el poderoso de Israel.
Se oirá, nadie lo detendrá.
Al poderoso,
Él es poderoso,
Él es poderoso. If what you're feeling is real, you don't need the music to back you up and make you shout louder. Si lo que estás sintiendo es verdadero, no necesitas a ninguna música. Solamente Él es digno en esta noche. Todo mano alzada en este lugar. Cargaste tú mi cruz en libertad. Con tu vida compraste. Y ahora tú yo soy. Proclamaré tu bondad para siempre. Digno de alabar, Cristo, nombre sin igual. Digno de alabar, digno de alabar, Cristo, nombre sin igual. Anyone know he's worthy in the house?
We love you, Lord.
And now my shame.
And now my shame is gone. I stand amazed in your love undeniable.
Your grace goes on.
Your grace goes on and on.
Why don't you lift up the name of Jesus? Exalt his name.
Oh, your Lord, you're worthy, Jesus. You're worthy, God.
Be exalted now in the heavens as your glory fills this place. You alone deserve our praise. You're the name above all names.
Be exalted now in the heavens. Your glory fills this place.
You alone,
you alone deserve our praise. You're the name above all names. Oh. Be exalted now in the heavens. And your glory fills this place. You alone deserve our praise. You're the name above all names. Be exalted.
Serve our praise. Look, I know that this can come off as entertainment. This can come off as flashy music. This can come off as some kind of a show and a presentation. But I've come to tell you that's not what we're here to do. We're here to give honor to the one who is worthy of the honor. We're here to give glory to him who is worthy of the glory. Maybe other people made it about themselves, but tonight it's not about anybody. It's about Jesus. En esta noche no se trata de nadie más. No se trata de quién está aquí arriba, quién está presidiendo, quién va a predicar. Con todo respeto, pero esta noche se trata de darle honra y gloria a quien lo merece. Su nombre es Jesucristo. His name is Jesus. And at the sound of the name of Jesus, chains have to break. At the sound of the name of Jesus, demons have to flee. At the sound of the name of Jesus, miracles have to take place. I wonder if you'll just call on the name. Call on the name. Call on the más todo voz alzada ante el Señor. Tú eres digno
eternamente, digno,
impresionante,
impresionante.
Tú eres digno. Más con todo su corazón, tú eres
digno eternamente,
oh,
digno, impresionante,
digno,
solo ante ti yo me
levante esa voz ante el Señor en esta hora. Si tú sabes que Él es digno, if you know He's worthy. We bless your name, oh God. We bless your name. Oh, yo creo que Él merece mejor que eso. I know He deserves better than that right now. I said He deserves better than that right now. Clap your hands unto Jesus because He's worthy. Aplaude sus manos porque a Jesús, porque Él es digno. Él es digno. Él es digno. Él es
digno. Hallelujah. If you know He's worthy, could you give Jesus a great hand clap of praise? Come on, if it's for the King of Kings, let's give it to Him with everything that we have. And why don't you add a shout of praise with that applause? He's worthy to be praised. Our God is worthy of the honor and the glory forever and ever. And praise the Lord, everybody. There is a powerful presence of the Lord in this place. We thank God for His presence. We thank God for the blessing of being back in Long Beach, California for our National Youth Conference. How many of you are glad to be back for our National Youth Conference? God has been good to us, granting us the blessing of being here once again. And I thank the Lord for the blessing that He gives me of being here and being able to preach His word. I want to give honor to our Bishop President, Dr. John Fortino, and the General Board of the Apostolic Assembly for their approval to participate in this wonderful youth conference. Thank God for our Bishop President and for his leadership during this very pivotal moment of the church. How many of you are glad for our President, our leader? God bless him, his precious wife and family, the General Board as well. I want to appreciate our National Youth President, Pastor Jacob Rodriguez, for the wonderful leadership that he's given the National Messengers of Peace as well. God bless him, his precious wife, our National Youth Board. God bless them, the excellent job they are doing. Can we thank the Lord for them? Wonderful leadership, tremendous job in this National Youth Conference. Last night, our president blessed us, and we are so thankful for the word that he shared with us. I want to give honor to my pastor, my father, Bishop Frank Romo. He couldn't be here, but I want to honor him and thank God for him. Also very blessed that my bishop of the District of Arizona, Bishop Sam Rojas, he is here, and I want to honor him as well, and his precious wife, and the wonderful Arizona district that I belong to. We love them very much. Thank the Lord for my wife that's here, Aiko, my children. Some of them are in the children's ministry, the juniors ministry. Thank God for all those that are doing that ministry as well. God bless them. To my church that we so humbly get to serve, PFAC, many of them are here, some are watching. We love you. Thank you so much. 2 Kings chapter 4, beginning at verse 18. The second book of Kings chapter 4, we're going to read verses 18 through 20. And then in the same chapter, jump down to verse 32. 2 Kings chapter 4, beginning at verse 18, and this is how it reads. And the child grew. Now it happened one day that he went out to his father, to the reapers. And he said to his father, "My head, my head." So he said to a servant, "Carry him to his mother." When he had taken him and brought him to his mother, he sat on her knees till noon and then died. Now jump down with me to verse 32, same chapter, 2 Kings 4. When Elisha came into the house, there was a child lying dead on his bed. He went in therefore and shut the door behind the two of them and prayed to the Lord. And he went up and lay on the child and put his mouth on his mouth, his eyes on his eyes, and his hands on his hands. And he stretched himself out on the child, and the flesh of the child became warm. He returned and walked back and forth in the house, and again went up and stretched himself out on him. And the child sneezed 7 times, and the child opened his eyes. I want to preach to you with the help of the Lord for a few moments from the subject, resurrected to return to the field. Resurrected to return to the field. Somebody say, in Jesus' name, God bless you. You can be seated in the wonderful presence of the Lord. I believe every one of us here is well aware of how fast things can change. One moment you are celebrating, planning, and anticipating the future. then all of a sudden, everything changes. An atmosphere of joy can quickly turn into one of confusion. And I can imagine for some of us, maybe all of us, somewhere in the last 20 months, we have been able to sympathize to a certain extent with the woman in our text. This notable woman, as the Bible describes her, added a room to her house for the prophet. And because of her display of faith, God granted her her request. And she had a son. Her gratitude to God in time gave way to a gut-wrenching plea for a miracle. In a moment, everything changed. Although this woman's faith is worthy of a closer examination, I want to spend the rest of my time here looking closely at her son, the young boy, because I believe he represents this generation. I'll say that again. He represents this generation of young people who, like this young child, you and I are an answer to prayer and at the same time, the devil's worst nightmare. Oh, I wish I had somebody here today that would agree with me that this generation of apostolic believers, we are an answer to prayer, but we're also the devil's worst nightmare. I want us to look not only at the road to his resurrection, but the reason he was resurrected. The first thing I want to notice about this story, number one, the enemy will try to stop you from getting to the field. In verse 18, we read that the young child leaves his home and heads out to meet his father and the reapers in the field. There was something that caused him to want to leave his house and then drew him to the field. In the Bible, the field is symbolic of a place of service and ministry. More particularly, Jesus explained it as the field is a world that is in need of a savior. Can I say that every child of God should feel the impulse of the Holy Ghost drawing you to the field, drawing us to a place of service and ministry, to a world that is in need of Jesus? But I want you to notice something very specifically in verse 18. The Bible says the child grew. Someone say the child grew. The day came where this child grew and left his house for the field. There is a moment when growth has taken place that you realize that you can no longer just sit in the house. When you have really grown in your walk with the Lord, something on the inside of you begins to tell you, I just can't no longer find a comfortable spot to sit. I've got to get out and I've got to serve. I've got to go out to the field. First, there is growth and maturity. And there's a drawing to go out to the field and do something great for God. I wonder if here tonight there is anybody that feels the draw or the pull of the Holy Ghost to the field of service and ministry. You realize I've sat here long enough in the house. I need to get out to the field. This happens when you feel God calling you to something great. So you're being drawn to the field. It could be a call to serve in a greater way in your local church, doing something to reach people in your city, or even a burden for the mission field. But like this young boy, you feel something drawing you to the field. But I must caution you, the enemy will do everything he can to stop you from getting to the field. How many of you know that to be true? Because if you go to verse 19 with me, the Bible says that at some point, this young boy cries out to his father, my head, my head. In our pursuit to do a work for God, there will always be an enemy that will try to stop God's purposes from being fulfilled in our lives. And many times, the first place he will attack you is in your head or your mind. We don't know exactly what caused the child's sickness, whether it was dehydration, the sun, or the elements, but we do know that the area that he was afflicted was his head. Can I tell you, during this particular season, this pandemic, the enemy has unleashed an assault on the mind of God's people. For the last 20 months, he's been trying to sow seeds of doubt, seeds of discouragement, seeds of deception, and even depression in the mind of God's people and God's servants. We've been afflicted not only in our bodies, but in our minds. But I'm here to tell you, under the anointing of the Holy Ghost, it is the will of God that we have victory in our minds. Oh, I'm talking to somebody that came to National Youth Conference being tormented in your mind. I've come to somebody and the devil's been attacking your mind, your will, and your emotions. But in the name of the Lord Jesus, I declare you free right now in your mind. Oh, I know we're at National Youth Conference, but I feel deliverance in the house. I dare you to look at somebody and tell them, I declare you free in your mind. Romans 12 and 2 says, and don't be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Philippians 2 and 5 says, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. Isaiah 26 and 3 says, you will keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on you because he trusts in you. Philippians 4 and 7 says, and the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds through Christ Jesus. What are you doing, preacher? I'm giving you ammunition to have victory in your mind. We're not losing in the area of talent. We're not losing in the area of ability, but we're losing the battle for our mind. Somebody needs to tell the devil, you can't have my mind. My mind belongs to Jesus. I said, my mind belongs to Jesus. And the reason he attacks your mind is to keep you from getting to the field. And the enemy has launched an attack on the mind of our church to keep us from fulfilling our purpose in the field. The devil is after the mind of this generation. But somebody needs to raise themselves up and rise up tonight and say, devil, you can't have my mind because I've got work to do in the field. This young child had a purpose to fulfill that we'll see a little later. So the enemy attacks him in his mind, his head. So what are we to do when the enemy afflicts our minds? The second thing we find in this story is the road to your resurrection and victory always goes through the church. Someone say the church. In verse 19, after the son cries out to his father, my head, my head, the father tells his servant, carry him to his mother. Paul says in Galatians 4 and 26, but Jerusalem, which is the mother of us all. Jerusalem in the Bible was the city of God. In the Old Testament was the center of Jewish worship. Also, the Shunammite woman of our story is a picture of the church. Can I tell you, if we're going to be resurrected to fulfill our purpose in the field, we need the church. The miracle for this young child began when they brought him back to the house. I don't know about you, but I'm thankful for the church. Oh, I wish I was going to get a few more witnesses than that. I said, I'm grateful for the church.
because it's the church where you're going to be saved. It's the church where you're going to be delivered and set free. It's the church where you're going to be healed. It's the church where you're going to be instructed, ministered to, equipped, and sent out to the field. We need the church. I know there are many trying to play down the effectiveness and relevancy of the church, but here to tell you that on your way to your destiny, it will stop at the church. If God is going to resurrect in me what has died, my passion, my purpose, my promise, my power, it's going to happen in the church. The Father knew if something is going to happen, you need to carry him to his mother. Why? There's hope in the house. There's victory in the house. You'll find what you need in the house of God. And I've come to tell somebody, you've come to the right house tonight because everything you need is in the house. I don't know what this was used before, but it was said last night. Tonight it's the house of God and the doorway to heaven. It's encouraging to know that there was a servant that was willing to help carry the boy to his mother. I believe God is looking for servants that will be willing to carry some people to their mother, to the house, back to the church. The miracle started when a servant obeyed his master and carried the child back to the house. In this last hour, there are people who have fainted in the field that need to be carried to their mother. They need to be taken back to the house of God. Is there anybody willing tonight that would say, I'll find somebody that has fainted in the field and I'll be willing to carry them back to the house? Resurrection, restoration, and victory can be found in the church. The third thing we see in our story is that a dead promise needs a living anointing. I'll say that again, a dead promise needs a living anointing. We heard it said last night and it was confirmed in the Holy Ghost. There is no substitute for the anointing. In verse 31, the prophet Elisha sends his servant Gehazi to lay his staff on the child. And your Bible says that nothing happened. Gehazi was the obedient servant, but he wasn't the man of God. You see, when you need a miraculous touch of God in your life, you cannot settle for substitutes. I don't need something that looks like the anointing or someone that knows someone that is anointed. I need the real thing. Because the only thing that's gonna make the difference in my life is the anointing. And we must refuse to settle for substitute. Emotion is not anointing. Volume is not anointing. It's the anointing that destroys the old.
I don't know about you, but I want the real thing. Verse 34 says that the prophet Elijah went up and lay on the child. The prophet stretched himself out and he covered the child. It was uncomfortable. It was unorthodox. It was awkward. But it was what God wanted to begin the stages of an incredible miracle. When the prophet covered the dead body of the child, there was something that began to happen. The Bible declares that warmth began to spread into the body of the dead child. May I say tonight that if you're going to experience a resurrection in your life, you need to be covered. You need to have a spiritual covering over your life. The Holy Ghost has impressed upon me tonight that if we're going to be successful in the field of service and ministry, we need to be covered. Let me say it this way. We need a generation that will allow themselves to be covered by anointed leadership. God cannot resurrect you
and send you out into the field until you're covered. What does that mean, preacher? Until you're submitted to leadership. Until there's somebody in your life that can tell you when you should go. The miracle happened when the prophet, who symbolizes the anointing of the Spirit of God, covered the child. We need a generation that will allow themselves to be covered by anointed leadership. But hear me, I'm not just picking on the young people tonight. We need anointed leaders that are that will provide spiritual covering, guidance, and direction for this generation. Let's quit blaming them that they don't want to submit. We've got to give them something to submit to. We're picking on this generation. They're rebellious. They're this and they're that. They're looking for anointed leadership to get under that covering. That's why Elisha didn't leave Elijah, because he had it. And Elisha said, I want what you want. If we'll cover this generation, if we'll direct them, if we'll guide them, they'll go anointed to the field. If you have a pastor in your life, you're covered. If you have a man of God in your life, you're covered. But if you don't, you're not covered. It doesn't matter how many ideas and how many seminars you take and how many books you read, you will not be successful, because you need to be covered. It's the covering that brings the anointing. When we leave this convention tonight, we need to leave here covered. Does somebody want to be covered today? I want to be covered. I need the covering of anointed leadership over my life. I need a pastor over my life. I need a bishop over my life. I need leadership over my life so that we can succeed in the field. Let me hurry. The next thing the prophet did in verse 34, the Bible says he put his mouth on his mouth, his eyes on his eyes, and his hands on his hands. Why is that important? Because you can go to the field. Before you do that, God needs to touch your mouth so that you can speak. Your eyes so you can see, and your hands so you can serve. God wants his church to return to the field with mouths that will speak his word, with eyes that will see that the fields are white for harvesting, and hands that will be the hands of Jesus to serve those that are in need. Someone here tonight needs to say, Lord, touch my mouth. God, touch my eyes. God, touch my hands so I can serve. Would you lift your hands for a few seconds right now and say, God, touch your eyes. I want to see the fields wide on harvest. Touch my mouth. I want to speak your word. Touch my hands. I want to serve those that are in need. I'm getting ready to close. Verse 35. Watch what it says. Then the child sneezed 7 times. And the child opened his eyes. Why would the Spirit of God include this small detail in this story? You can give me the next slide, please. In 2012, researchers from the University of Pennsylvania discovered that sneezing is the nose's natural way to reset. When you sneeze, it resets your nostrils and your lungs and your respiratory system. A sneeze tells your respiratory system and your nostrils, take a break, reset, and let's go again. You're not hearing me.
So when the child sneezed, the Spirit of God was saying, child, rest, reset, and go again. I've come to preach to the Apostolic Assembly. We're in a reset. It's time to set ourselves, take a break, and then go back to the field. God in this last hour is trying to reset his church and cause us to return to the field.
Hear me, I'm almost done. Give me another 2 minutes and I'm done. Hear me. We've been hiding long enough. We've been in survival mode long enough. We've been waiting for the pandemic to pass. Brother Anthony, once this is over, then we're going to get going. Our church is just waiting for things to calm down, and then we'll relaunch our small groups, and then we'll go out and outreach again, and then we'll start our intercessory ministry again. I'm telling you, if you haven't done it now, start doing it. We're resetting and we're going again. We've got to go back to the homes, back to the field, back to prayer, back to intercession, back to reaching our world. I hear the Holy Ghost telling the Apostolic Assembly, we got to go back now. We don't have time to waste. We can't wait until things correct themselves. God has reset the church to get us to go back again. Tell somebody, tell it, go back again. And I close. Once God resurrects your passion, your calling, your vision, then he resets your purpose. The pandemic has provided the church an opportunity to allow the Holy Ghost to hit the reset button and get us back to what really matters, to what is really essential, and that is the following. The church must be in the field. There is a world that needs the apostolic message. And can I be bold enough to say there's a world that is looking for the apostolic assembly? It's time for a reset of our focus and our purpose. It's time to return to the field. And I finish. If you fast forward 11 years, you will find an incident in 2 Kings chapter 9. Verses 1 and 2. And Elisha the prophet called one of the sons of the prophets and said to him, get yourself ready. Take this flask of oil in your hand and go to Ramoth Gilead. Now when you arrive at that place, look there for Jehu, the son of Jehoshaphat. The prophet Elisha needed someone to anoint a king. Some commentaries state, and even some rabbinical teachings hold, that this young man that was chosen to anoint the new king is the same young man that was resurrected in 2 Kings chapter 4. Why does that matter? Because this King Jehu would destroy one of Israel's most difficult problems, Queen Jezebel. God resurrected this young man and returned him to the field because he had a purpose to fulfill. Now you know why the devil was trying to stop him. Now you know why the enemy caused him to faint and attack him in the field, because he was trying to stop him from taking the anointing and bringing down Queen Jezebel. Stand with me all over this house. Why does the enemy stop you from going to the field? Because when you come back to the field, you come back with anointing in your hands. And the devil knows that if this generation ever gets anointing in its hands and on its heart, we will bring down the kingdom of darkness.
we will bring down the spirit of Jezebel. And that's why he's trying to stop you from returning to the field. But in the name of Jesus, there is resurrection power in this place to raise you up, reset you, and return you back to the field. Is there somebody here tonight that could lift their hands to heaven and say, God, return me to the field? Lift your hands and lift your voices all over this house. There's resurrection power in this building. There's anointing in this building to resurrect your passion, to resurrect your purpose, to send you back to the field. Would you pray, God, resurrect my passion? God, reset my purpose. God, return me to the field. He raises you up to return you to the field. Somebody give God a great hand clap of praise tonight.
El salmista declaró, cantar alegres a Dios, habitantes de toda la tierra. Servir a Jehová con alegría. Venir ante su presencia con regocijo. Reconocer que Jehová es Dios y Él nos hizo y no nosotros a nosotros mismos. Pueblo suyo somos y oveja de su prado. Entra por sus puertas con acción de gracia, por sus atrios con alabanza. Alabarle, bendecí su nombre. Y aquí está la clave, hermanos, porque Jehová es bueno. Dije, Jehová es bueno y para siempre su misericordia. Habrá un testigo en esta noche que Jehová es bueno. Dije, habrá un testigo que Jehová es bueno. Si Él ha sido bueno, denle un aplauso al Señor. For over 20 months, we experienced a pandemic that shook the world. Durante más de 20 meses hemos experimentado una pandemia que sacudió al mundo entero. We heard many reports of how bad things were going to get. Escuchamos muchos informes de lo mal que se iba a poner las cosas. Reports that brought at times fear, discouragement, panic, and unbelief. Reportes que traían por momentos temor, desánimo, pánico y a veces incredulidad. But the prophet Isaiah declared, asked the question, whose report will we believe? And he answered and he said, we will believe the report of the Lord. And I don't know about you, but today we believe the report of the Lord. Isaías preguntó, ¿qué reporte nosotros vamos a creer? Y él contestó y dijo, nosotros vamos a creer el reporte del Señor. Can I tell you that during these 20 months, the church chose to believe the report of the Lord? Puedo decirles a todos ustedes que durante estos 20 meses la iglesia eligió creer el reporte de el Señor. And we experienced the greatest financial increase in the midst of a pandemic. La iglesia experimentó un mayor aumento financiero en medio de una pandemia. So today, we continue to believe the report of the Lord that the greatest revival of the church is about to descend upon the church like never before. Yo quiero creer en este día que el avivamiento más grande de la iglesia está por descender sobre la iglesia. Habrá alguien que cree esto conmigo en este. Si usted lo cree, dé un aplauso fuerte al Señor. I know that some of us gave offering last night. Hermano, yo estoy consabido que muchos de nosotros dimos ofrenda anoche. But I want to encourage you to make an extra effort. Last night, we witnessed something unprecedented. Bishop Prado said that his wish was to collect $100,000. He went over $100,000. And we love our young people. ¿Cuántos aman a los mensajeros de paz? A ver, dije, ¿cuántos aman? How many love the young people? So, I want to unite with Bishop Prado, and I believe that we can reach the 200,000 mark tonight with the help of the Lord. Creo que podemos alcanzar los 200 mil dólares en esta noche. Yo voy a ser el primero. Mi iglesia, vamos a dar $1,000. Y voy a pedir a los sugieres que pasen rápido porque tengo 25 minutos solamente. So, I'm going to invite all of those that would like to unite with me. We need to reach a $200,000 mark tonight with the help of the Lord. Here comes my good friend. Thank you. Come on, brother. Thank you so much. South Central District, $1,000. Bishop Prado, San Fernando. He gave last night $1,000. He gave $2,000 last night, $1,000 tonight. Bishop Valdez, thank you, $1,000. Bishop Rojas, Arizona, $1,000. Bishop Salazar, $1,000. Our Vice President, God bless you, thank you. Bishop Aguilar, thank you so much, $1,000. God bless you. Bishop Joe Prado, $1,000. God bless you. Bishop Espinosa, thank you. God bless you, $1,000. Where are you from, brother? North Central District, $1,000. Central Phoenix, $1,000. Pastor Jimmy Morales, $1,000. We're gonna do it in Jesus' name. We're going to do it in Jesus' name. Pastor Anthony Romo, God bless you, $1,000. Judah and Rebecca Montenegro, $1,000. Pastor Hassel, Frisco, Texas. Texas in the house. $1,000. Bishop Gilbert Andrade, $1,000. God bless you. Somebody else. Bishop Lofton, all the way from Boston, $1,000. God bless you. Come on, vamos a hacer una bendición en este día con la ayuda del Señor. Sister, where are you from? Phoenix, $1,000. God bless you. Pastor Abel Duarte. Bakersfield, $1,000. God bless you. Bishop Castro. West Phoenix, $1,000. Thank you. God bless you. $1,500. Thank you. God bless you. Northeast Coast District, $1,000. La Roca Eterna Church, $1,000. Familia Santos, Santos Solutions, $1,000. Bishop Jesse Rodriguez, $1,000. Bishop Velasco, God bless you, $1,000. In Jesus' name. I said, in Jesus' name. We all gonna give tonight. Hermano, prepárese porque todos vamos a dar en esta noche. Production Concrete, Bakersfield, $1,000. They're telling me there's 26. Pastor Quesada. Summit Church, $1,000. God bless you. Si usted quiere cooperar con $1,000, ¿por qué no pasa? My friend, God bless you. Pastor Elder Pelayo, $1,000. God bless you. Somebody else, alguien más. In Jesus' name. Pastor Payan, where you from, young man? God bless you. $1,000. We need five more. Five more in Jesus' name. Cinco más con $1,000. Five more. Alguien diga gloria a Dios. O no, dígalo más fuerte. No, dígalo más fuerte. Where are you at? ¿Dónde están? Our president, $1,000. God bless you. God bless you. We need four more. Four more. Cuatro más. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. All right. You don't have $1,000, but you could give 500. Here comes another brother. God bless you. God bless you, Pastor. Thank you so much. Pastor Jeffrey Rodriguez. God bless you. We need three more. Men and Women Link, 500. Pastor Rodriguez, $500. God bless you. Pastor Quesada, Jonathan Quesada, God bless you. Bishop Frank Quesada, God bless you. Si usted tiene $500 y quisiera cooperar en este día, ¿por qué no pasa? You got $500. Come, let's give. Pase con $500. ¿Cómo se llama? Manhattan, New York, $500. Bishop Joseph Rodriguez, $500. Pastor Omar Cortez, $500. Pastor Cortez, David Cortez, Houston, $500. God bless you. First Lady Garcia, $500. Women Speak, $500. Pastor Hassel, $500. All right. Sigan pasando, hermanos. Come, come. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. 500, usted quiere que Dios lo bendiga, ¿por qué no siembra algo en este día? If you want God to bless you, sow a seed in Jesus' name. Jesus. Alguien diga gloria a Dios. Oh no, dígalo más fuerte, por favor. Ahí viene nuestro hermano. San Bernardino, $500. We need five more. Five more. God bless you. Brother Sendejas, God bless you. Bishop Moran, $500. God bless you. God bless you. Manuel Carrillo from Bakersfield, $500. God bless you. Felipe and Aurelia Renteria, $500. $1,500. God bless you. Jesus' name. I'm going to challenge all the young people today, because I noticed that last night a lot of pastors and a lot of bishops came up here and gave offering. But I want to challenge 100 young people, maybe 200. You have $100. Borrow it from your neighbor. Real quick, we need 100 young people, 100 messages apiece. If you want to give to the Lord, you want God to bless you, I want you to come. 100, quickly, come, come. 100 jóvenes que den $100. Come, we got one all the way from Austin. 2, 3, Midland, West Texas, God bless you. God bless you, second, God bless you. Come on, you got $100, come, young people. Si usted trae $100, ¿por qué no pasa en este día? Quickly, quickly. $100. Hermano, si usted quiere cooperar, hermano, hermana, con $100, ¿por qué no pasa? Why don't you come? Come. God bless you. God bless you. Thank you so much. Come on, we got 8 minutes. Tengo 8 minutos. In Jesus' name. $100. Every young man and every young lady should get up and give $100. In Jesus' name. Jesus' name. Yes, yes, yes. Si usted quiere ser una bendición, pase con $100. $100. In Jesus' name. Que no se acabe el gozo, hermanos. Si usted está gozoso, diga gloria a Dios. Oh. Come, come, pase, pase. $100, they're coming, they're coming. Yes, 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 yes. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. There's an usher up in the upper level. Por allí, hermanos, hay ujieres allá arriba para que usted no tenga que bajar. Si usted quiere cooperar con $100. Pastor Arias just gave $500 online. God bless you. Thank you so much. Si usted quiere dar a través de, if you're online watching and you want to give, please. Si usted quiere dar a través, hermanos, si nos está mirando a través de online, por favor, estamos pidiendo que coopere con los mensajeros de paz en este día. Thank you so much. Keep on coming. Keep on coming. They're coming. Thank you so much. Dios les bendiga a todos. In Jesus' name. Jesus' name. I'm going to invite everyone to stand to your feet. Voy a invitar a todos que se pongan de pie, por favor. Yo sé que ya dieron $1,500, $100, todos. Pero voy a invitar que saque un billete de $20. Everybody, get a $20 bill. And we're going to come and bring it to the Lord. Yo quiero que los sugieres se pongan aquí. Just come here to the front, aquí enfrente. Si usted trae $20, you don't have $100, but you got $20. Get a $20 bill out. I know you gave $150 and $500, but in Jesus' name, todos los que traen $20, ¿por qué no pasan en este día? Come, in Jesus' name. Queremos saludar a todos los hermanos que nos están viendo a través de media. God bless you. Thank you for joining. Pase, hermanos, con $20. Come. Pase, todos, pase con $20. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Yes, yes. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name. Thank you so much. Thank you for giving. Yes. So much. Yes, yes. Hermanos, voy a invitar a todos que levanten su mano. Vamos a darle gracias a Dios. Everyone lift up your hand. Todos. Señor, te damos muchas gracias. Porque lo de lo recibido de tu mano, de eso te damos en este día. Te pido que bendigas a todos los que han dado en este día. Que tú bendigas el sacrificio, Señor. Honralos, bendice. Bendice sus familias, sus hogares, a los obispos, pastores. Bendice sus congregaciones. A todos los que pudimos dar, Señor. Multiplícales, Señor. A ti te damos la honra, la gloria. Desde hoy y para siempre, un aplauso fuerte al Señor. Dios los bendiga a todos.
Come on, let's clap a little louder than that if you have a reason to be thankful to God. Si tiene motivo por qué darle gracias a Dios, de un aplauso a ese más fuerte, al que vive reina para siempre, to the one who reigns and lives forever. I don't know about you, but I have a reason to thank God today. I said I have a reason to thank God today. Hallelujah, we love you, Lord. We thank you tonight. Let's keep worshiping the Lord. Wandering into the night, wanting a place to hide this weary soul. Stagger bones. And I tried with all my might, but I just can't win the fight. I'm slowly drifting, a vagabond. Just when I ran out of road, I met a man I didn't know. And he told me that I was not alone.
Turn me around, place my feet on solid ground.
I thank the Master,
I thank the Savior,
because he healed my heart. Choice but to believe. My doubts are burning like ashes in the wind. So long to my old friends, burden and bitterness. You can't just keep it moving. No, you're not welcome here. From now till I walk the streets of gold, I'll sing of how wayward son has found his way back home. He picked me up, turned me around. He placed my feet on solid ground.
I thank the Master, I thank the Savior,
because he healed my heart.
He changed my name, forever free. I thank the Master, I
dream comes out of the grave. Every dead ministry comes out of the grave.
Strong and close. Cristo, hermanos, praise the Lord, everyone. You may return to your seats. Se siente la presencia de Dios en este lugar. Qué bueno que vinieron todos. It's great that you all came to this great convention. Even greater than that is the fact that Jesus has chosen to be here in the midst of us, and we honor his name, we honor his person, and we're grateful for the power of God moving in this house Thank God for all of the preachings that we have heard throughout this great gathering. It is my honor at this time, es mi honor en este momento, presentarles a ustedes el presidente de nuestra iglesia, la Asamblea Apostólica de la Fe en Cristo Jesús, al Dr. John Fortino. It's my honor to present to you the president of the Apostolic Assembly, the leader of our church, Dr. John Fortino. If you know Dr. Fortino, you know that he has a heart for our church and a passion for our young people, and that he is an instrument that God has greatly used to communicate his love and his passion for the church. So it is an honor for me at this moment to present to you our leader. President, would you come and speak to us the word of the Lord?
Toda la gloria es para Cristo Jesús.
All the glory belongs to our Lord Jesus.
Toda la gloria es para Cristo Jesús.
All the glory belongs to our Lord Jesus.
¿Cuántos alaban el nombre del Señor?
How many can praise the name of Jesus?
¿Cuántos glorifican el nombre del Señor?
How many glorify the name of the Lord?
Yo sé que lo pueden hacer un poco mejor.
I know you can do it better than that.
2 años esperando este momento.
We've been waiting 2 years for this moment.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Alabado sea el nombre del Señor.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Siéntense, hermano, gracias.
You may be seated, my brothers. Thank you.
Antes de traer la palabra de Dios,
before I enter into the word of the Lord,
quisiera felicitar a todos los predicadores.
I would like to congratulate all the preachers.
Qué tremendo trabajo que hicieron.
What a tremendous work they've done.
Pastor Jacob.
Pastor Jacob.
Excellent, excellent.
Excelente,
work.
Pastor.
Pastor Jimmy Morales.
Pastor Jimmy Morales.
Beautiful, beautiful.
Hermoso.
Yeah, he brought an amen corner here.
Trajo una esquina de amén aquí.
And Pastor Anthony Romo.
Pastor Anthony Romo.
Those are the ones that I heard.
Fueron los que nosotros pusimos.
Excellent job. God bless you.
Excelente trabajo. Que Dios los bendiga.
Tenemos buenos predicadores.
We have good preachers.
Quiero honrar a la mesa directiva que está aquí conmigo.
I want to honor the general board that is here with me.
Y quiero decirle a toda la iglesia.
And I want to tell all of the church.
Que ha sido un placer.
That it has been a pleasure.
Una alegría.
A joy.
Trabajar con estos hombres.
To work with these men.
A través de estos años,
throughout this time,
hemos creado una amistad.
We have created a friendship.
Y doy gracias a Dios por cada uno de ellos.
And I thank God for each of them.
Y su esposa que están aquí con nosotros, Dios las bendiga.
Their wives that are here with us, God bless you.
Ellas se llaman BMWs.
Se llaman BMWs.
Bishop, no, board members' wives.
Esposas de
BMWs.
De los miembros de la mesa directiva.
God bless you, BMWs.
Dios las bendiga.
Let's give it a hand.
Un aplauso a ellas.
Beautiful.
Hermoso.
And my wife Sarah.
Mi esposa Sara.
Mis hijas que están aquí.
My daughters that are here.
Mi yerno.
My son-in-law.
Y mis dos futuros yernos.
And my two future son-in-laws.
El 10 de diciembre se casa Verónica.
On the 10th of December, Veronica's getting married.
Y en unos 20 años más se casa Debbie.
And about 20 years later, Debbie will get married.
Gracias a Dios por mi familia que siempre me ha apoyado.
God bless my family who has always supported me.
Quiero honrar a todos los obispos que están aquí.
And I want to honor all the bishops.
Todos los pastores que están aquí en este auditorio.
All the pastors that are here.
Gracias por la ofrenda.
Thank you for the offerings.
Y me siento muy contento ver a mi amigo Gary Vázquez.
And I'm very happy to see my friend Gary.
Este hombre es un milagro caminando.
This man is a walking miracle.
Porque Dios todavía no ha terminado con él.
Because God's not done with him yet.
Hay mucho que Dios tiene que hacer con él y con su familia.
There's so much more that God has to do with him and his family.
Hoy a la mañana tuve el honor.
This morning I had the honor
de estar con el ministerio de sordos.
To be with the deaf ministry.
Y cuando llegué al auditorio donde estaban ellos,
when I arrived at the auditorium where they were at,
me dijeron, Presidente, queremos que usted pase por el medio.
They said, Pastor, President, we want you to walk through the middle.
Normalmente uno entra siempre por el costado, ¿verdad?
Normally you just enter kind of through the side.
Pero me dijeron, queremos que vaya por el medio.
But they said, we want you to walk down the middle.
Y cuando pasé por el medio, me hicieron así.
And when I was walking through the middle, they went like this.
Todos los que estaban ahí me hicieron así.
Everyone that were there, they went like this.
If you don't know what this means, it means I love you.
Si no sabe lo que quiere decir esto, quiere decir que te amo.
And I want to tell all of you.
Y les quiero decir a todos.
We, the whole Apostolic Assembly.
Toda la Asamblea Apostólica.
We love you.
Los amamos.
And I know you guys are taking this ministry to the next level.
Yo sé que están tomando este ministerio a otro nivel.
Quiero que se pongan de pie.
I want you to stand to your feet.
Y quiero que le den un aplauso con alabanza a Jesús.
I want you to give the Lord a hand praise to Jesus.
This is the way that they clap.
Así es que ellos aplauden.
I don't know if you knew that.
No sé si sabían eso. Yo no lo sabía.
Did you know that?
Lo sabían. Yo no lo sabía.
This means I'm clapping to
Jesus. Eso es aplauso a Jesucristo.
Esto quiere decir estoy dándole palmas a Jesús.
That means I'm giving a hand praise to Jesus.
I want the whole assembly.
Quiero que toda la asamblea.
Vamos a darle un aplauso.
Let's give a round of applause.
To them.
A ellos.
And I want you guys to see the whole assembly.
Y quiero que ustedes vean la asamblea.
Hay 38 millones de sordos en el mundo.
There are 38 million deaf in the United States.
En Estados Unidos, perdón. 38 millones.
38 million.
Que necesitan ser alcanzados.
That need to be reached.
Tenemos. Well, they came prepared, my goodness. All right. Tenemos, ya tenemos. Just go like this, go like this.
Háganlo así.
They don't hear you.
Ellos no lo escuchan, háganlo así.
There we go.
Ahora sí.
Tenemos un ministro ordenado.
We have an ordained minister.
Que también es sordo.
That's also deaf.
Tenemos un profesor de la Universidad de Nuevo México.
We have a New Mexico State University professor.
Que también es sordo.
That is also deaf.
Look at that.
Él es el ministro.
Él es el ministro y hoy predicó la palabra de Dios.
He is the minister and he preached the word of God today.
Con sign languages.
En lenguaje de señales.
Y les voy a decir algo más.
And I'm going to tell you something else.
Ellos también reciben el Espíritu Santo.
They also receive the Holy Spirit.
You have to go like this, they don't hear you.
Háganle así porque no los escuchan.
Ellos también reciben el Espíritu Santo.
They also receive the Holy Spirit.
Yo no sé si ustedes se han fijado.
I don't know if you've noticed.
Pero on these screens that we have on the side.
Pero en las pantallas que tenemos a los lados.
Tenemos una pequeña pantallita.
We have a small screen inside of there.
And that's the sister or the brother that we have over there.
Esa es la hermana o el hermano que está ahí en la esquina.
Y una de las cosas interesantes aquí.
And one of the interesting things.
Era de que ellos me mandaban textos o emails.
Is that they would send me texts and emails.
Decían, President.
Me decían, Presidente.
The service was beautiful.
El servicio estuvo hermoso.
And I was wondering myself.
Y yo me preguntaba.
¿Cómo se dan cuenta?
How do they know?
Es que ellos tenían a alguien más que les traducía.
It's because they had someone else that would translate.
Ahora ya no necesitan a nadie más que les traduzca.
And now they don't need anyone else to.
Ellos miran las pantallas.
They see the screens.
Y miran esa persona al costado.
And they see that person on the side.
Y así como ustedes alaban a Dios.
And just as you praise God.
Ellos también alaban a Dios en sus
casas. They also praise God in their homes.
Dios los bendiga.
God bless you.
Dios los guarde.
God keep you.
Les voy a confesar algo.
I'm going to confess something to you.
I'm Italian.
Yo soy italiano.
This for us means something completely different.
Para nosotros esto quiere decir algo totalmente diferente.
I don't know if we have another Italian here in the house.
I don't know if there's any other. No sé si hay otro italiano aquí en la casa.
Is there another Italian here in the house?
Habrá otro italiano aquí.
Okay. Esto significa otra cosa.
This means something else.
So, imagínate entrar a un edificio.
So imagine entering into a building.
Donde la gente te recibe.
Where everyone receives you.
Así.
Like that.
Dije, for the love of God, Le digo, Marty, ¿dónde me trajiste, Marty?
I said, Marty, where did you bring me to?
No, pero es que esto significa I love you.
But that's because this means yo te amo.
In sign language, significa
señales,
I love you.
En su lenguaje, es yo
y
te
me
amo.
Sentí muy contento de mirar
este
grupo.
And I felt very happy to see this.
Y queremos que Dios los use y que Dios los bendiga poderosamente.
And we want God to bless them and use them greatly.
Amados hermanos, estamos listos para oír la palabra de Dios.
Brothers, we are ready to hear the word of the Lord.
It's very hard to be the last preacher.
Siempre es difícil ser el último predicador.
I told Brother Anthony, please leave me something.
Le dije al hermano Anthony, por favor, déjame aunque sea algo.
Es muy difícil ser el último predicador.
It's very hard to be the last preacher.
Pero Dios tiene algo para ustedes en esta noche en el nombre del Señor.
But God has something for you here tonight.
Y creo que Dios nos va a bendecir a todos.
And I believe that God is going to bless us all.
Los hermanos que están allí arriba.
The brothers that are there.
No los puedo ver.
I can't see you
por las luces.
Because of the lights.
Pero ustedes pueden alabar a Dios con sus teléfonos
but
también.
You can praise God with your phones as well.
Turn on the light in your phone.
Pueden encender la luz en su
and
teléfono.
That means that you're worshiping God.
Y eso quiere decir que están alabando a
and
Dios.
You can do the same thing here.
Y pueden hacer lo mismo aquí.
This is a place of worship.
Este es el lugar de alabanza.
This is a place of worship.
Este es el lugar de alabanza.
Aquí le gritan a una pelota.
Here they scream to a ball.
Le gritan a diferentes cosas.
They scream to different things.
Pero nosotros vamos a gritar al Señor
but
de la gloria.
We are going to scream to the God of glory.
Vamos a alabar al Señor de la gloria.
We are going to praise the God of glory.
Yo no sé si ustedes pueden mirar para atrás.
I don't know if you can see back.
Pero what I see right now is beautiful.
Pero lo que veo es algo hermoso.
Así que pueden hacer eso.
So you can do this.
Cuando quieran glorificar a Dios.
When you want to worship God.
No lo hagan todo el tiempo porque se les va a acabar la batería del teléfono.
Don't do it the whole time because you're going to waste the battery.
Pero cuando quieran alabar a Dios.
But when you want to praise God.
Ustedes lo pueden hacer.
You can do it.
También bendigo a los hermanos de Miami que están aquí con nosotros.
I also bless our brothers from Miami that are here with us.
Jonathan, God bless you, Jonathan.
Jonathan, Dios te bendiga.
Me dijo, Pastor, don't forget that today is my birthday.
Digo, no te olvides, Pastor, que hoy es mi cumpleaños.
Le digo, if I see you, I'm going to say it.
Le dije, si te veo, lo voy a decir.
Pero mira qué inteligente, se sentó right in front of me.
Look how intelligent it is. Se sentó primero en medio enfrente de mí.
Imposible perderlo, mira.
Impossible to miss it.
God bless you, Jonathan. Y todos los hermanos de Miami que están aquí.
And all the brothers from Miami that are here.
Los amamos en el nombre del Señor.
We love you in the name of the Lord.
Voy a pedir que estén de pie, por favor.
I'm going to ask you to please stand in the name of the Lord.
Y quiero que abran sus Biblias. Tengo algunos pasajes.
I'm going to ask you to open your Bibles. I have some scriptures.
Quisiera leer tres versículos que van a aparecer en la pantalla.
I want to read three scriptures that will show up on your screens as well.
Primero se encuentra en el segundo libro de Crónicas.
The first one is found in 2 Chronicles.
Muy conocido por todos nosotros.
Very well-known text.
Versículo, capítulo 7, verso 14.
Chapter 7 and verse 14.
Vamos a ir a Habacuc.
And then we'll go to Habakkuk.
Capítulo 3, verso 2.
Chapter 3 and verse 2.
Y por último, Lucas 24:49.
And lastly, Luke 24:49.
Y quisiera compartir con ustedes lo que Dios puso en mi corazón.
And I would like to share with you what the Lord has put on my heart.
Dice el segundo libro de Crónicas 7.
The second book of Chronicles, chapter 7.
Si se humillare mi pueblo.
If my people would humble themselves.
Sobre el cual mi nombre es invocado.
Which are called by my name.
Y oraren.
And pray.
Y buscaren mi rostro.
And seek my face.
Y se convirtieren de sus malos caminos.
And turn from their wicked ways.
Entonces yo oiré desde los cielos.
Then will I hear from heaven.
Y perdonaré sus pecados.
And will forgive their sin.
Y sanaré su tierra.
And will heal their land.
Habacuc 3 dice,
Habakkuk 3 says,
Oh Jehová,
Oh Lord,
he oído tu palabra,
I have heard thy word,
y temí,
and was afraid.
Oh Jehová,
Oh Lord,
aviva tu obra en medio de los tiempos.
Revive thy work in the midst of the years.
En medio de los tiempos.
In the midst of the years.
Hazla conocer.
Make it known.
Y en la ira.
And in wrath.
Acuérdate de la misericordia.
Remember mercy.
Lucas 24:49.
Luke 24 and 49.
He aquí.
Behold.
Yo enviaré la promesa de mi padre.
I will send the promise of my father.
Sobre todos vosotros.
Upon you.
Pero quédense vosotros en la ciudad de Jerusalén.
But tarry ye in the city of Jerusalem.
Hasta que seáis investidos.
Until you be endued.
Del poder de lo alto.
With power from on high.
Yo creo con todo mi corazón.
I believe with all my heart.
Que Dios quiere bendecir esta iglesia.
That God wants to bless this church.
De una forma sobrenatural.
In a supernatural way.
Como nunca antes lo vimos nosotros.
As we have never seen before.
Estoy creyendo con todo mi corazón.
I am believing with all my heart.
Que Dios nos va a sorprender.
That God will surprise us.
Oiga bien las palabras que estoy usando.
Listen well the words that I am using.
Dios,
God,
nos va a sorprender.
Will surprise us.
Con el avivamiento más grande,
with the greatest revival
que jamás hayamos experimentado,
that we have ever experienced.
Dios va a sorprender a la iglesia.
God will surprise the church.
Esto no es del hombre.
This is not of man.
Esto viene directamente del cielo.
This comes directly from heaven.
Amados hermanos,
dear brothers,
el próximo año termina mi presidencia.
Next year my presidency ends.
Han sido los mejores años de mi vida.
They have been the best years of my life.
Me he cansado un poco.
I've gotten a bit tired.
El cuerpo también lo siente.
The body feels it.
Pero le prometí a Dios trabajar hasta el último día.
But I promised God that I would work to my very last day.
Y quiero terminar este año.
And I want to finish this year.
Dejando en el corazón de todos ustedes.
Leaving in all of your hearts.
Este bendito tema que Dios me ha dado.
This blessed theme that God has
unidos
given.
Expandiendo el reino de Dios.
United expanding the kingdom of God.
Con poder.
With power.
Pero en avivamiento.
But in revival.
En el nombre de Jesucristo.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen. Amén. Hasta yo me sorprendí con eso, hermano.
Even I got surprised with that.
Siéntense, por favor. Gracias.
You may be seated, please.
Es increíble escuchar hoy en día las cosas que apasionan a la gente.
It is incredible to think of what people are passionate about today.
La pasión de una persona,
a person's passion,
se determina por el tiempo,
is determined by the time,
o la cantidad de horas que esa persona,
or the amount of hours that the person,
invierte en esa pasión,
invests in that passion.
Jesucristo lo puso de otra forma.
Jesus put it this way.
Jesucristo dijo en San Mateo 6:21.
Jesus said in Matthew 6:21.
Porque donde está o esté vuestro tesoro,
for where your treasure is,
allí también estará vuestro corazón.
There will your heart be also.
Si usted quiere saber lo que hay en el corazón de alguien,
so then if you want to know what's in someone's heart,
cuente las horas que invierte en algún asunto.
Count the hours that they invest in something.
Y allí va a encontrar el tesoro de esa persona.
And there you will find this person's treasure.
Algunas se apasionan con los deportes.
Some are passionate about sports.
A otros se les ilumina la cara.
Others, their faces light up.
Cuando hablan de ir a cazar.
When they talk about hunting.
O ir a pescar.
Or fishing.
O hablan de armas.
Or even of guns.
Se les ilumina el rostro.
Their face lights up.
Hay personas que son fanáticos de la política.
There are others that are fans of politics.
De las bienes raíces.
Of real estate.
De la bolsa de valores.
Of the stock market.
Muchos jóvenes,
many young people,
pero no aquí,
but not here,
se desvelan por las noches jugando video games.
They stay all up all night gaming.
No quiero decir que son pecadores.
I'm not saying they're sinners.
Sencillamente estoy diciendo que la pasión,
I am simply saying that passion,
se mide por el tiempo que se le dedica a un asunto.
Is measured by the time you spend on an issue.
Todas estas prácticas seguro que tienen algo de emoción.
All of these practices, sure, there's some emotion to them.
Si no, no lo hicieran.
Otherwise, they wouldn't do them.
Pero uno que busca el avivamiento espiritual,
but one that speaks, seeks spiritual revival,
lo único que lo apasiona son las cosas espirituales.
The only things that they're passionate about are spiritual things.
Si usted quiere ver a un hijo de Dios emocionado,
if you want to see a child of God emotional,
háblele del Espíritu Santo,
or excited, speak to them of the Holy Spirit.
Háblele del poder de Dios en la vida de una persona.
Speak to them of the power of God in someone's life.
Háblele acerca de los milagros.
Speak to them of miracles.
Y si quiere verme emocionado a mí,
and if you want to see me excited,
hábleme acerca de una iglesia que crece.
Speak to me of a church that is growing.
Hábleme del rapto de la iglesia.
Speak to me of the rapture of the church.
Pero si me quiere ver realmente emocionado,
but if you truly want to see me excited,
hábleme del poder de Jesucristo sobre los demonios.
Speak to me of the power of God over demons.
Y esas cosas me apasionan.
And those things make me excited.
Los verdaderos hijos de Dios,
the true children of God,
se apasionan,
are passionate,
invierten su tiempo,
they invest their time,
invierten sus horas,
they invest their hours,
en las cosas de Dios,
in the things of God.
Y eso es lo que determina la pasión.
And that is what determines passion.
David dijo, yo me alegré.
David said, I was glad.
Con los que me decían,
when they said unto me,
vamos a la casa de Dios.
Let us go into the house of the Lord.
Cuando alguien te dice, vamos a la iglesia.
When someone tells you, let's go to church.
¿Cómo usted se siente?
How do you feel?
¿Qué siente dentro de usted?
What is it that you feel within you?
Amados hermanos, en estos días,
dear brothers, in these times,
es imposible que un predicador tome el púlpito.
It's impossible for a preacher to take a pulpit.
Y no hable acerca de la pandemia.
And not speak of the pandemic.
No podemos ignorar lo que ha pasado.
We cannot ignore what has happened.
No podemos ignorar las malas noticias.
We cannot ignore the bad news.
Yo sé que esto nos ha golpeado a todos.
I know that this has hit all of us.
Pero quiero decirles que Dios todavía sigue en el trono.
But I want to tell you that Jesus is still on the throne.
A nosotros nos tomó por sorpresa.
It took us by surprise.
Pero a Dios nada lo toma por
But nothing takes God by surprise.
Dios sigue sentado sobre su trono.
God continues to be seated upon his throne.
Y aunque parezca que Dios abandonó la iglesia,
though it would seem that God has abandoned
Dios
the church,
sigue siendo Dios.
God continues to be God.
Y él tiene la última palabra
and
en nuestra
he
vida.
Has the last word in our lives.
Tuvimos una reunión.
We had a meeting.
A Zoom
meeting
con los pastores de África,
with the pastors of Africa,
y el misionero en Sudáfrica,
and the missionary in South Africa.
No sé si el obispo Provencio se recuerda.
I don't know if Bishop Provencio remembers this.
Su nombre es Angus Chico.
His name is Angus Chico.
Nos dijo, presidente.
He said, president.
Lo que le está pasando a la iglesia,
what is happening in the church,
es como un partido de fútbol soccer.
It's like a soccer game.
Y wow.
I said, wow.
A ver, explíqueme.
I said, okay, go ahead and explain this to me.
Dice, es que en el primer tiempo nos están metiendo unos cuantos goles.
He says, it's because it's the first half and they're scoring a few goals on us.
Pero todavía no terminó el partido.
But the game isn't over yet.
Ahora viene el segundo tiempo.
Now the second half is coming.
Y cuando llega el segundo tiempo,
and when the second half arrives,
estamos en el equipo que tiene a Jesucristo.
We are in the team that has Jesus.
Y como con nosotros está Jesús,
and since Jesus is with us,
yo le garantizo, presidente,
I guarantee you, president,
este partido lo va a ganar la iglesia,
that this game will be won by the church.
Yo no sé cuántos de ustedes creen que la iglesia va a salir triunfante.
I don't know how many of you believe that the church will be triumphant.
Yo estoy convencido.
I am convinced
que la iglesia va a ganar.
That the church will win.
No importa lo que diga el mundo.
It doesn't matter what
no
the world
importa
says.
Lo que diga el diablo
it doesn't
mismo.
Matter what the devil himself says.
Esta iglesia va a ganar.
This church will win.
Al fin del tiempo.
At the end of the game.
Mire, y es cierto.
Look, it's true.
Que lloramos a los hermanos que se fueron.
We cried for our brothers that left.
Yo he llorado mucho, hermanos.
I've cried a lot.
Amigos,
friends,
pastores,
pastors,
obispos,
bishops.
Pero estamos en el equipo ganador.
But we're on the winning team.
Y cuando vayamos al cielo,
and when we go to heaven,
van a ser los primeros que van a estar ahí.
They're going to be the first ones there.
Mientras vayamos entrando,
while we're walking in,
ellos van a estar dándonos la bienvenida.
They're going to be giving us the welcome.
Alabado sea el nombre del Señor.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
En Cristo Jesús la iglesia nunca pierde.
The church never loses.
Si usted lo cree,
if you believe it,
póngase de pie y grite,
stand on your feet and show glory to God.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Shama.
Yes, Lord.
Whoa. Suena ese shofar.
Let the shofar sound.
Yo no lo puedo ver, no sé ni dónde está.
I don't even know where it's at.
Hermano, nos han metido unos cuantos goles.
Dear brothers, they've hit a few goals.
Pero no tengan miedo,
but
iglesia.
Don't fear, church.
Vamos a ganar este juego
we are going to win this game in the name of the Lord.
Porque somos triunfantes.
Because we are
somos más que vencedores.
We are more than overcomers.
Alguien alabe a Dios allí atrás.
Praise God back there.
Somos más que vencedores.
We are more than conquerors.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord. Woo. Siéntese si puede.
You may be seated if you can.
Cuando Jehová hiciere volver la cautividad,
when the Lord turned again the captivity of Zion,
seremos como los que sueñan.
We were like them that dream.
Entonces nuestra boca se llenará de risa.
Then was our mouth filled with laughter.
Y nuestra lengua de alabanza.
And our tongue with singing.
Entonces dirán entre las naciones,
then they said amongst the heathen,
grandes cosas ha hecho Jehová.
The Lord has done great things for them.
Yo no sé cuántos los que están aquí.
I don't know how many of you that
pasaron
are here.
Por el COVID.
You went through COVID.
Me dijo mi doctor, tú eres un survivor.
My doctor told me that I was a survivor.
Yo no sé cuántos los que están aquí.
No sé, I don't know how many of you
pasaron
that are here.
Pasaron y Dios les dio la victoria.
Went through it and God gave you the victory.
Si tú pasaste por el COVID.
If you went through COVID.
Quiero que te pongas de pie.
I want you to stand on your feet.
Y por 10 segundos.
And for 10 seconds.
Dale gracias a Dios
give
por la
thanks
vida.
To God for life.
Dale gracias a Dios
give
por la vida.
Give thanks to God for life. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
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 Oh, alguien alaba el nombre del Señor.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Algo va a pasar aquí en esta
something's
noche.
Going to happen here tonight.
Algo va a pasar
something's
aquí para la gloria de Dios.
Here for the glory of God.
Amados hermanos, solos no podemos.
Dear brothers, we can't do it by ourselves.
Todas las crisis.
All the crisis.
Que ha experimentado la iglesia primitiva.
That the primitive church has experienced.
Todas fueron muy difíciles.
They were all difficult.
Muchos cristianos morían a diario.
Many Christians would die daily.
Debido a la persecución.
Because of persecution.
Líderes y apóstoles.
Leaders and apostles.
Morían como malhechores.
They would die as criminals.
Comenzando con Nerón el año 64 después de Cristo.
Beginning with Nero in 64 AD.
Nuestra iglesia, la iglesia,
our church, this church,
experimentó 10 persecuciones.
Experienced 10 persecutions.
En un periodo de aproximadamente 3 siglos.
In a period of about 3 centuries.
Sin descanso.
Without rest.
Constantemente.
Constantly.
Imagínate el culto donde estaban los hermanos.
Can you imagine the services where the brothers were?
Así como este.
Just like this one.
Y de repente alguien viene.
And all of a sudden someone arrives.
Y le dice el predicador.
And says to the preacher.
Hermano.
Brother.
Y acaban de cortar la cabeza al apóstol Pablo.
They just chopped off the apostle Paul's head.
Y hubo un silencio como este silencio.
There was a silence like this one.
Esas cosas golpean.
Those things, they hit you.
Pero la iglesia hizo una pausa.
But the church made a pause.
Y siguió alabando a Dios.
And then continued to praise God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Estas eran las noticias que recibían nuestros hermanos a diario.
This was the news that our brothers would receive daily.
Yo he recibido noticias como estas todas las semanas.
They received news like this every week.
Allí en el banquete de los pastores.
There in the pastor's banquet.
Mientras estábamos en el banquete.
As we were in the banquet.
Me llega un texto.
I receive a text.
Y nos dice que este pastor que tenemos.
And it says this pastor
en
that
Kenosha,
we have,
Wisconsin.
In Kenosha, Wisconsin.
Acababa de fallecer.
Had just passed away.
En pleno banquete.
Right in the middle of the pastor's banquet.
Y me puse a pensar.
And I began to think.
Esto es parte de lo que vivió la iglesia primitiva.
This is part of what the primitive church experienced.
¿Y qué vamos a hacer cuando escuchamos estas noticias?
And what will we do when we hear this news?
¿Seguro que nos duelen? Claro que nos duelen.
Sure, does it hurt? Yes, it hurts.
¿Seguro que tenemos sentimientos? Claro que sí.
Yes, we have our emotions. We
¿Seguro
definitely
que queremos
do.
Tirar la toalla? Claro que
definitely
sí.
Definitely we want to throw the towel in.
Pero hay una fuerza dentro de nosotros.
But there is a strength within us.
Que yo no te lo lo puedo explicar si tú no la tienes.
That I cannot explain it if you don't have it.
No hay manera de explicar el poder del Espíritu Santo.
There's not a way to explain the power of the Holy Spirit.
Si la persona no tiene el poder dentro de él.
If the person doesn't have that power within him.
No lo puede entender.
The mind cannot reason with that.
¿Cómo puede ser posible que esta gente loca?
How is it possible that these crazy people?
Sabiendo que ha muerto este hermano.
Knowing that this brother died.
Sabiendo que ha muerto este hermano.
Knowing that this sister died.
Aún así siguen alabando
and
a Dios.
So they continue to praise God.
Esto es lo que hacía la iglesia primitiva.
This is what the early church would do.
Alabado sea el nombre del
Blessed
Señor.
Be the name of the Lord.
Porque para nosotros,
because for us,
el vivir es Cristo.
Is Christ.
Y el morir es ganancia.
And to die is gain.
Ellos no se desvanecieron.
They did not faint.
No se hicieron vapor.
They did not vaporize.
Entraron a la presencia del Dios creador del universo.
Of God, the creator of the universe.
Corre, hermano, corre en el nombre del Señor y alaba a Dios. Aleluya. Yo fui a consolar una familia.
I went to console a family.
Y vengo a consolarlos.
And I come to console them.
Y mientras los estaba consolando,
and
estaba llorando.
As I was consoling them, I was
porque
crying.
Tenía un dolor en mi corazón.
Because I had a pain in my heart.
Y la viuda me dice,
and the widow says,
Pastor, no llore.
Pastor, don't cry.
La viuda me
the widow said this to me.
Pastor, no llore.
Pastor, don't cry.
No llore.
Don't cry, Pastor.
Yo sé que mi esposo está en un mejor lugar.
I know my husband is in a better place.
Allí no hay dolor.
There's no pain there.
No hay tristeza.
There's no sadness.
Lo único que ha pasado es que se nos adelantaron.
The only thing is that they've gone before
nomás
us.
Se nos adelantaron, hermano.
They just went ahead of us.
Porque querramos o no, para allá vamos todos.
Because like it or not, we're all heading.
Aunque
there.
No digan amén, así es, para
even
allá vamos
say
todos.
Amen, that's where we're all going.
Todos vamos para allá.
We're all headed in that direction.
Alabado sea el nombre del Señor.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Pero, ¿cómo aguantaba la iglesia esto?
But how can the church withstand all of this?
Imagina, estaba en otro culto.
Can you imagine being in another service?
Acaban de matar a Esteban.
They just killed Stephen.
El que cantaba en los cultos, dirigía los cultos.
The one that would direct the services.
Lo acaban de matar en la plaza.
They just killed him there in the plaza.
Y lo mataron con piedras.
And they stoned him to death.
Hicieron un silencio.
There was a
pero después siguieron alabando a Dios.
But then they continued praising God.
¿Por qué es eso?
Why is that?
Porque Jesucristo les dijo,
because Jesus said to them,
yo enviaré la promesa de mi Padre sobre vosotros.
The promise of my Father upon
pero entiendan esto.
You. But understand this.
Quédense en Jerusalén.
Stay in Jerusalem.
No se animen a hacer nada.
Don't do anything else.
No toquen ninguna puerta.
Don't not even knock on a
no
door.
Evangelicen a nadie.
Don't evangelize
no
anyone.
Echen fuera ningún demonio.
Don't cast out any demons.
Espérense que venga el Espíritu
stay
Santo.
Wait there until the Holy Spirit.
Y cuando llegue el Espíritu Santo,
and when the Holy Spirit comes,
les va a dar una fuerza sobrenatural,
a supernatural power,
que les va a dar la fuerza para resistir,
that will give you the power to resist,
y para hacerle frente a todas las a todos los problemas y crisis de la iglesia,
to stand up against any problem and crisis that comes to the church.
Jesús le dijo,
Jesus said,
ustedes solos no pueden.
You can't do it alone.
¿Entiendes, iglesia?
Can you understand this,
entiende,
church?
Pastor?
Can you understand this,
usted
pastor?
Solo no puede.
You can't do it alone.
Los jóvenes,
the youth,
young people,
jóvenes,
by yourself,
solos,
you cannot do it.
No lo pueden hacer.
I don't care what anybody else tells
no
you.
Importa lo que le diga alguien más.
You by yourself, you cannot
solo
do it.
No lo puedes hacer.
Oh, but let me tell you.
Pero deja decirle.
If you have the Holy Spirit,
si tienes el Espíritu Santo,
yo quiero que Dios empiece a bautizar con el Espíritu Santo aquí ahorita.
To begin to baptize with the Holy Spirit right now.
Siento que Dios va a llenar con el Espíritu Santo.
I feel that God is going to fill with the Holy Spirit.
A gente que está aquí en este auditorio que todavía no tiene.
That are here in this auditorium that don't have it yet.
Alabado sea el nombre del Señor.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Y Dios va a avivar el espíritu de alguno de ustedes.
God is going to revive the spirit of
que
some
el enemigo
of you.
Lo tenía opacado.
The enemy had it oppressed.
Pero ¿por qué es esto?
But why is this?
Es que solo no podemos.
Because we can't do it by ourselves.
La iglesia primitiva no podía soportar.
The early church could not resist.
Así como nosotros no podemos soportar.
Just like with us.
Tantas muertes.
So many deaths.
Tanta tristeza.
So much sadness.
Es difícil soportar esto.
It's difficult to be able to take.
Pero hay una fuerza por dentro.
But there is a strength on the inside.
Que es el Espíritu Santo de Dios.
That is the Holy Spirit of God.
Que le ha dado a la iglesia.
That has given the church.
Que le ha dado a todos aquellos que son bautizados.
Everyone that is baptized.
Yo no sé cuándo fue la última vez que hablaste en lenguas.
I don't know when the last time was that you spoke in tongues.
¿Cuándo fue la última vez que hablaste en lenguas?
I don't know when was the last time you spoke in
tongues. Alabado
sea
el nombre del Señor.
Blessed be the name of the
Iglesia,
Lord.
Necesitamos el poder.
Church, we need the power.
Y la investidura del Espíritu Santo.
And to be endowed of the Holy Spirit.
Por alguna razón,
for some reason,
hemos limitado el poder del Espíritu
we
Santo.
Have limited the power of the Holy Spirit
en nuestros cultos,
in our services
y en nuestras reuniones,
and in our meetings.
Y miren qué tranquilo que les estoy hablando.
And look how calm I'm speaking to you.
Para que sea el Espíritu el que hable.
So that it'll be the Spirit that
lo hemos limitado.
We have
hemos dejado de sentir la necesidad.
And I've not stopped feeling the need
de orar por el poder del Espíritu
of praying
Santo.
For the power of the Holy Spirit.
Me recuerdo en nuestras convenciones.
I remember in our conventions.
I'm going to talk to the old timers here.
Quiero hablarle a los
la vieja
ancianos,
guardia, the old timers.
La vieja guardia.
Me recuerdo de nuestras convenciones.
I remember our conventions.
Y cultos que se caracterizaban.
And the services that were characterized.
Por el derramamiento del Espíritu Santo.
By the outpouring of the Holy Spirit.
Y la necesidad de orar.
And the need to pray.
Y quiero decir esto con todo mi corazón.
And I want to say this with all my heart.
A mí me gusta alabar a Dios.
I like praising God.
Cuando ustedes me miran a mí haciendo esto.
When you see me doing this.
Yo estoy danzando en el Espíritu.
I'm dancing in the Spirit.
Antes danzaba con los pies.
Before I danced with my feet.
Pero no quiero dejar de danzar.
But I don't want to stop dancing.
No quiero dejar de alabar a mi
I
Señor.
I don't want to stop praising my God.
Estuve en una convención.
I was in a convention.
Y me hicieron danzar.
And they wanted me to dance.
Y al siguiente día no pude ir a la reunión de pastores.
And the next day I couldn't go to the pastor's meeting.
Me empezaron a doler las rodillas.
My knees began to hurt.
Así que
so
decidí
then,
danzar de esta manera.
I decided to dance in this way.
E invito a todos los de la vieja guardia.
And I invite all of the old timers.
Que no dejen de alabar a Dios.
To not stop praising God.
No importa que la rodilla te duela.
It doesn't matter if your knees hurt.
No importa que los pies te duelan.
It doesn't matter if your feet hurt.
Pero sigue danzando.
But keep dancing.
Sigue alabando.
Keep praising.
Sigue glorificando.
Keep glorifying.
Que tus hijos te vean alabando a Dios.
That your children will see you praising God.
Que tus hijas te vean alabando a Dios.
Your daughters will see you praising
God. Que tus nietos te vean
alabando a Dios. Your grandchildren will see you praising God.
Ahora queremos el poder.
Now we want the power.
Pero que no se pase de la hora.
But we don't want it to go into overtime.
Ahora queremos que Dios bendiga nuestros programas.
Now we want God to bless our programs.
Pero se olvida que la bendición y el avivamiento están en su programa.
But we forget that the blessing and the revival are in His program.
Ahora nos conformamos con entrar al auditorio.
Now we're satisfied with just entering the auditorium.
Dios quiere que entremos a su presencia.
And God wants us to enter into His presence.
Ahora llegamos a la convención para pasar un buen tiempo.
Now we arrive to convention to have a good time.
Y Dios quiere darnos un avivamiento.
And God wants to give us a revival.
Ahora hacemos las cosas para impresionar.
Now we do things to impress.
Y Dios hace lo que hace para salvar.
And God does what He does to save.
Ahora queremos que el público nos aplauda.
Now we want the public to applaud us.
Dios quiere que el público se arrepienta.
But God wants the public to repent.
Ahora queremos hacer las cosas a nuestra manera.
Now we want to do things our way.
Dios bendice cuando hacemos las cosas a su manera. ¿Qué tenían los cultos del pasado?
What did the services of old have?
Los coritos de antes.
The songs of before.
Todos los coritos se cantaban en el mismo tono.
All the songs were sang in the same
todos
tune.
Tenían el mismo tono.
They all had the same tune.
No era difícil ser músico.
It wasn't difficult to be a
usted
musician.
Tocaba en sol.
If you sang in that certain tone,
y podía elegir todo un culto.
And you can go through the whole service.
Y cambiaban los coritos.
And they would change the songs.
Pero el tono siempre era el mismo.
The tune was always the same.
Y el ritmo era el mismo.
And the rhythm was the same.
Y nos sentíamos bien.
And we felt good.
Y salíamos contentos.
And we left happy.
Salíamos tocados por el Espíritu Santo. Porque se le daba más énfasis al poder transformador del Espíritu Santo. Iglesia, yo felicito a estos músicos.
Church, these musicians.
Estos cantores son profesionales.
These singers are professionals.
Yo ya no sé cómo tocar la guitarra.
I don't know how to play the guitar anymore.
Antes tocaba la guitarra.
Before I used to play it.
Ahora ni me animo a tocar la guitarra.
I won't even touch one.
Pero tenemos que entender que lo más importante,
but we must understand that the most important
alabado sea el nombre del Señor, es el poder
de
Dios que transforma.
That transforms.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Jacob.
Jacob.
¿De qué vale saltar aquí?
Why, what good does it do us to jump?
Y después nos sentamos.
And then we sit down.
Y seguimos peleado con el hermano que está al lado nuestro.
And we keep fighting with our brother that's sitting next to us.
¿De qué vale todo eso si no le hablas a tu papá y a tu mamá?
Does it do you if you won't even speak to your
father
and your mother?
¿De qué vale todo eso si tienes odio en el corazón?
What good does it do you to do all this if you have hatred in your heart?
El poder del Espíritu Santo.
The power of the Holy Spirit.
Lo que hace transformar tu
corazón. It transforms your heart.
Lo cambia.
It changes it. It breaks it.
Alguien bendiga el nombre de
Someone bless the name of the Lord.
Dios quiere darnos un avivamiento.
God wants to give us a revival.
En este tiempo.
In this time.
Yo llegué a la edad de 13 años a una iglesia apostólica.
At the age of 13 years old, I arrived at an apostolic.
Y me recuerda el testimonio del doctor Amin.
And I remember Dr. Amin's testimony.
13 años.
13 years old.
Una iglesia pobrecita.
A little poor church.
Estaban remodelándola.
They were remodeling it.
Una montaña de arena en medio del templo.
A bunch of sand right in the middle of the temple.
Un chamaquito de 13 años.
A little 13-year-old boy.
Pero empezaban a hablar en lenguas.
But they would begin to speak in tongues.
Y yo sentí un imán que me pegaba al templo. Quería salir corriendo, pero el poder del Espíritu Santo no me dejaba salir. Y en ese momento sentía la voz de Dios.
Yo
no sabía que Dios hablaba. Y me decía, arréglate con tu papá. Pídele perdón a tu primo. Tienes que dejar esto. Tienes que dejar aquello.
And you need to leave the other.
Y eso solamente lo hace el poder del Espíritu Santo.
And that is only done by the power of the Holy Spirit.
Y cuando el poder del Espíritu Santo está en medio de
nosotros, the power of the Holy Spirit is in our midst.
El Señor quiere bendecirte.
The Lord wants to bless you.
Pero quiere transformarte.
But he wants to transform you.
Alguien bendiga el nombre del
Someone
Señor.
Bless the name of the Lord.
Iglesia, necesitamos un avivamiento.
Church,
en este tiempo.
We need a revival in this time.
Me han preguntado, presidente.
They've asked me, president.
¿Cuál es la nueva normalidad?
What is the new normal?
¿Cómo tiene que vivir la asamblea apostólica?
How must the apostolic assembly live?
¿Y no, la nueva normalidad?
The new normal?
Ahora se habla mucho de new normal.
Se habla de
la nueva normalidad.
The new normal?
¿Cuál es la nueva normalidad?
What is this new normal?
En oración le pedí al Señor.
In prayer I asked the Lord.
El Señor me dijo, dile a la iglesia.
And the Lord told me to tell the church.
La nueva normalidad para la asamblea
apostólica. That the new normal for the apostolic assembly.
Es el avivamiento antiguo.
That old time revival.
Amados hermanos,
dear brothers,
óyeme lo que te digo.
Listen to what I'm telling you.
Esto es lo único que nos va a sacar con victoria.
This is the only thing that will take us forward in victory.
No, no más vamos a salir de la pandemia.
Not only will we leave the pandemic,
vamos a salir de la pandemia en victoria.
But we're going to leave it in victory.
Mirando para atrás,
looking back,
y diciendo gloria a Dios,
and saying glory to God,
porque Jesús nos dio la victoria.
Because God gave us the victory.
Necesitamos avivamiento
we
en este
need
tiempo.
Revival at this time.
Amen.
Amen.
Alguien bendiga el nombre del Señor.
Someone bless the name of the Lord.
Alguien póngase de pie.
Someone stand on your feet.
Y quiero que hagan un poco de ruido para
I
Dios.
Want you to make a little noise for God.
Allá atrás.
Back there.
Alaben a Dios.
Praise God.
Quiero verlos alabar a Dios.
I want to see you praising God.
Shamaha.
Erobo shat arabakaya.
Esto es lo que nos va a sacar adelante, Jacob.
This is what will take us forward, Jacob.
This is what we have to tell the young people.
Esto es lo que le tenemos
this
que
is
decir
what
a los
we need for the years to come.
Esto es lo que necesitamos para
esto
los
lo que necesitamos nosotros.
This is what we need.
Alabado sea el nombre del Señor. Que se llenen del Espíritu Santo.
That they be filled
que
with the
sientan
Holy
el avivamiento
that
de Dios
they
en
the
su vida.
Of God in their lives.
Alabado sea el nombre del Señor.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Y cuando lo siente,
and when you feel it,
el miedo tiene que salir huyendo.
Fear has to flee.
El miedo tiene que salir huyendo en el
fear
nombre del
has
Señor.
To leave in the name of the Lord.
Alguien bendiga el nombre del Señor.
Someone bless the name of the Lord.
Siente, yo sé que ya quieren.
I know that you want to go.
Yo sé que ya quieren saltar.
I know you want to
pero déjenme terminar.
Just let me finish for a moment.
¿Cómo se logra esto, hermano? ¿Cómo se logra esto?
How can this be done?
How do I know? How do I get this thing?
¿Cómo puedo obtener esto?
How do I get to that level?
¿Cómo puedo llegar a ese nivel?
El avivamiento no es una varita mágica.
Revival isn't a little magic wand.
Ven conmigo, yo te toco y
come with me, I touch you and
y te agarra electricidad.
And then electricity comes over you.
Hay muchos tontos que creen esas cosas.
There are many dumb people that think that way.
El avivamiento no es una varita mágica.
Revival isn't a little magic wand.
Esto es un proceso.
This is a process.
Y alguien habló ayer acerca del proceso.
And someone spoke about the process.
Y quisiera desafiarlos.
And I would like to challenge.
I want to challenge.
Los quiero retar. Para más.
Todos los jóvenes que están aquí.
All the young people that are here.
I know you're thinking in the party after convention.
Yo sé que están pensando de la fiesta después.
Te puedes olvidar del party after the convention.
You can forget about that.
Te puedes olvidar un poquito de eso.
You can forget about that for a moment.
Te estoy llevando a la dimensión del espíritu.
I'm taking you to the spiritual dimension.
Quiero que sientas el poder.
I want you to feel the power.
Que creó el universo.
That the creator of the universe created. Hallelujah.
Los voy a llevar al libro de Ezequiel.
I want to take you to the book of Ezekiel.
Capítulo 47.
Chapter 47.
He aquí debajo del umbral del templo.
And afterward he began under the door of the house.
Salían aguas hacia el oriente.
And behold the waters issued out from under it.
Y cuando el hombre salió hacia el oriente.
And when the man went out to the east,
llevaba un cordel en su mano.
He took a string in his hand.
Entonces midió 1,000 codos.
And he began to measure 1,000 cubits.
Y me hizo pasar por las aguas.
And he caused me to go through the waters.
Por los tobillos.
Up to my ankles.
Después midió otros 1,000 codos.
And then he measured another 1,000.
Y me hizo pasar por las aguas hasta las rodillas.
And caused me to get unto my knees.
Después midió otros 1,000 codos.
Then another 1,000 cubits.
Y me hizo pasar por las aguas hasta la cintura.
And I went through the waters up to my waist.
Después me dio otro 1,000 codos.
And then another 1,000 cubits.
Y el río ya no se podía cruzar.
And the river couldn't be crossed
porque
anymore.
Las aguas habían crecido.
Because the waters had
y el río no se podía cruzar.
The river could not be crossed.
Sino a nado.
Except swimming.
Aquí nos habla de que este río.
It speaks to us that this river
tiene cuatro niveles de separación.
Has four levels of separation.
Separados por 1,000 codos.
Separated by 1,000 cubits.
Esto representa unos 1,200 pies.
About 1,200 feet.
Entre un nivel y el otro nivel.
Between one level to the next.
Fíjate qué interesante es esto.
And look how interesting this is.
Porque el hombre del cordel.
Because the man with the line, with the string.
No se iba para arriba.
He wasn't ascending.
Sino que se iba a la distancia.
But he was going to the distance.
No se trata de volar muy alto.
It wasn't about flying high.
Se trata de caminar firme.
It's walking firm.
Si tuviéramos que ir hacia arriba,
if we had to ascend,
para agarrar estas aguas
to,
espirituales,
receive these spiritual waters,
nadie lo lograría.
Then no one would be able to
sería
do
imposible
it.
Lograrlo.
It would be impossible to
es
achieve
imposible.
It. It's impossible.
Pero esto se trata de permanecer caminando.
But this is about remaining walking.
Oye esto.
Listen to this.
Aun cuando tus amigos abandonan.
Even when your friends abandon.
En este río espiritual.
In this spiritual river.
Se trata de caminar.
It's about walking.
Tú tienes que caminar.
You must walk.
Y vas subiendo de nivel.
And you're going from one level to the next.
En la medida que vas caminando firme.
In the measure that you are walking firmly.
No quieras llevar al último nivel.
Don't want to take to the last level.
Me dice, hermano presidente, qué fácil que es ser presidente, ¿verdad?
Brother, it must be easy, president, to be the president.
Nada más se pone ahí enfrente.
You just stand up there.
Predica.
You preach.
Y ya con eso se arregla todo.
And with that, everything is fixed.
Y este no sabe absolutamente nada de lo que está hablando.
This one doesn't know anything that they're talking about.
Esto es un proceso.
This is a process.
La gente quiere las luces.
The people want the lights.
La gente quiere el micrófono.
The people want the microphones.
Pero no quieren la trayectoria.
But they don't want that trajectory.
No les interesa la trayectoria.
They don't care about that trajectory.
No les interesan las lágrimas.
They don't care about the
las
tears,
luchas, las crisis, los problemas.
The struggles, the crisis, the problems.
Solamente creen que es un asunto de micrófono.
They only think it's all about the microphone.
Y es un asunto de luces.
And about lights.
No.
No.
Es un asunto de trayectoria.
It's a thing about your trajectory.
Para pasar de un nivel a otro,
by going from one level to the next,
tienes que caminar este camino del río.
Must walk this walk in the river.
Pero lo más hermoso que miro aquí,
but the most beautiful thing that I see here,
es que lo que hace el primer nivel,
is that what the first level does,
es mojarte los tobillos,
is it wets your ankles.
¿Qué quiere decir eso, hermano?
And then what does that mean, then,
en ese momento es cuando tú te decides,
in that moment is when you decide,
a entrar a una relación íntima
to
con
enter
Dios.
Into an intimate relationship with
y
God.
Lo que tú quieres ahora,
and what you want now,
es caminar con Dios,
is to walk with God,
y tus pies comienzan a firmarse,
and your feet begin to become firm.
Ya tus pies no se van hacia cualquier lado.
Your feet don't walk just anywhere anymore.
Vente conmigo.
Come with me.
Y ahí va el tonto con él.
There the dummy goes.
El que está en el río de Dios,
but he who's in the river
que metió
of God,
los pies dentro del agua,
put their feet in the water.
Te pueden tentar.
They can tempt
te
you.
Pueden decir un montón de
they
cosas.
Can tell you all kinds of
pero ya probaste el agua.
But you've already tasted
ya empezaste
the
a entrar en el agua.
You're already feeling the water.
Ya empezaste a sentir el poder de Dios en tu vida. Ya los pies no están chuecos. Ahora los pies están firmes. La gente te mira. Este muchacho, ¿para dónde va? Esta jovencita, ¿para dónde va? En el trabajo te empiezan a alabar. Usted es diferente a todos los demás. ¿Qué es lo que ha pasado? Es que el agua te está llegando a los tobillos. Ya empezaste a sentir el poder de Dios.
Begin to feel the power
ya los pies se están afirmando.
Your feet are becoming firm.
Y sigue caminando.
And you continue to walk.
Y Dios te sorprende ahora. El
and
agua
God surprises you because the water
llega hasta tus rodillas.
It arrives all the way up to your knees.
No es que tú subes.
It's not that you're going up.
Es que la cosa de abajo se hace más profunda.
Because the depth begins to get deeper.
Ahora tú te empiezas a meter más dentro del agua.
Now you're going further into the water.
Y cuando uno llega al nivel de las rodillas,
and when you get to that level of your knees,
ese es el nivel de la oración.
This is the level of prayer.
Tu papá no te tiene que decir, ve orar.
Your dad doesn't have to tell you, hey, go pray.
Solito te levantas por
you
la mañana.
Get up by yourself in the morning.
Nadie te tiene que decir que tienes que ir a orar.
No one has to tell you to go pray.
No tienes que escuchar a nadie.
You don't need to hear anybody.
Ya en ese momento empiezas a sentir.
In that moment you begin to feel.
Las ganas de buscar a Dios en oración.
The desire of seeking God in prayer.
Ya no son cinco minutos.
It's not 5 minutes anymore.
Ahora se convierte en media hora.
Now it becomes half an hour.
Hasta tu papá se sorprende.
Even your dad gets surprised.
¿Qué le está pasando a la muchacha?
Hey, hold on. What's going on with this
la veo en el cuarto que está orando.
I see her in her room praying.
Y está llorando.
And she's crying.
¿Será que el novio la dejó?
Did the boyfriend
¿será
leave
que
her?
Se peleó con alguien?
Did she get in a fight with somebody?
No, papá.
No, dad.
Es que he entrado en el no, río de Dios.
It's because I'm in God's river.
He entrado en la presencia de
Dios. I've entered into the presence of God.
Y ahora el agua me está llegando por la rodilla.
And now the water is up to my knee.
Amados hermanos, ese es el nivel.
Dear brothers, that's the level.
Del que es guerrero espiritual.
That person that's a spiritual warrior.
Dios me dijo hace muchos años.
God told me many years back.
Juan, el éxito de tu ministerio.
John, the success of your ministry.
No va a estar en tu boca.
Will not be in your mouth.
A veces se me olvida.
Sometimes I forget.
El éxito de tu ministerio no está en tu boca.
The success of your ministry is not
el éxito de tu ministerio está en tus rodillas.
The success of your ministry will be on
y cuando la cosa se pone dura,
and when things get hard,
cuando usted llega al tope,
when you get to the
cuando
end,
yo ya no sé más qué hacer,
I don't know what else
cuando
to
yo
do,
ya no sé más qué decir,
I don't know what else to
cuando
say,
ya no tengo más con quién
when
hablar,
I don't have who else to talk to,
me voy a los secretos de Dios,
I go into that secret place
y entro a la presencia del Creador
and
del universo,
enter to the presence of the Creator
y tu Padre que ve en los secretos.
Your father which sees in secret.
Y digo esto para la gloria de Dios.
And I say this for the glory of God.
Mi padre me ha visto mucho tiempo en secreto.
My father has seen me for a long time.
Y por eso nos ha recompensado en público.
That's why he has recompensed us.
La gloria no es para mí.
The glory isn't for me.
Yo no soy nada ni soy nadie.
I am nothing and no one.
La gloria le pertenece.
The glory belongs to him.
Él es el único digno.
He is the only one worthy.
Y tu padre que ve en lo secreto.
And your father which sees in secret.
Sigue caminando.
Keep walking.
Pasen los músicos, come on up. Y el agua dice aquí que le llegó por la cintura.
And then the water made it up to their waist.
Ese es el nivel de sujeción.
That's the level of subjection.
Cuando usted quiere agarrar a alguien verdaderamente,
when you truly want to get someone,
usted lo agarra de la cintura.
You get them by the waist.
Y esto representa el nivel de sujeción.
And this represents the level of subjection.
Dios no puede bendecir a los rebeldes.
God cannot bless the rebellious.
Dios no puede bendecir a los que buscan la división de la iglesia. Ahí no está el Señor.
God is not in
ahí
that.
No está el Espíritu Santo.
The Spirit, Holy Spirit isn't there.
El Señor bendice a aquellos que son sujetos.
God blesses those that are
sumisos a la voluntad de Dios.
To the will of God.
¿Saben lo que pasa cuando llegas al nivel de la cintura?
You know what happens when you get to that waist level?
Te metiste en el Getsemaní.
You get into the Getsemaní.
Entraste a la presencia de Dios.
Entered into the presence of God.
Señor, si es posible.
Lord, if it's possible.
Pasa esta copa de mí.
Let this cup pass of me.
Yo siento el llamado.
I feel the call.
De ir a predicar, pero.
Of going to preach, but.
Pero si es posible.
But if it's possible.
Saca esta copa de mí.
Take this cup from me, God.
Sácala.
Take it from me.
Yo siento el llamado a ir al campo misionero.
I feel the call to go to the mission field.
De servirte, Señor.
Of serving you, God.
Pero si es posible que se vaya.
But if it's possible for this to leave.
Me asusta esto.
This scares me, God.
¿Cómo voy a vivir?
How am I going to live?
¿De dónde va a venir el dinero para comer?
Where's the money going to come to eat?
¿Y cómo me voy a alimentar?
And how will I be fed?
¿Y cómo voy a alimentar a mis hijos?
And how will I feed my children?
¿Y cómo lo voy a hacer?
And how will I do this?
Si es posible, pasa esta copa de mí. Esa fue mi oración a Dios, hermano.
That was my prayer to God.
Eso fue lo que yo oré al Señor.
That is what I prayed to
cuando
God.
Dios me pidió que me dedicara a su obra.
When God asked me to be dedicated to his work.
Año 1990.
In 1990.
Dios me dijo, Juan, necesito que te dediques.
God said, John,
necesito
I need you
que
to
trabajes
dedicated.
Para mí.
I need you to work for me.
Yo soy ingeniero mecánico.
I'm a mechanical engineer.
Y el Señor, ¿y cómo voy a hacer?
And I said, God, how can I
¿cómo
do
se
this?
Va, ¿cómo voy a mantener a mi familia?
How can I maintain my family?
¿De dónde va a salir el dinero?
Where will the money come from?
¿Cómo le hago, Señor?
How can I do
ahí
this?
Ciudad de Miami.
There in the city of Miami.
Solo con pocas iglesias, ninguna iglesia alrededor.
No other church around me.
Pero el Señor me dijo, yo me voy a hacer
but
cargo de ti.
Said, I will take care of you.
Y le dije a Dios, voy a hacer un pacto contigo.
Said, God, I will make a covenant with you.
Yo le trabajé a mi jefe.
I worked for my boss.
Y todos los viernes me daba el cheque.
And every Friday he gave me my
ahora
check.
Te voy a trabajar a ti.
Now I'm going to work for you.
Tú eres el creador del universo.
You are the creator of the universe.
Estoy hablando de 1990.
I'm talking in 1990.
Hasta el día de hoy.
Till today.
Dios jamás me ha fallado.
God has never failed. Me.
Yo le dije al Señor,
I said to the Lord,
si es posible, pase esta copa de mí.
It's possible for this cup to pass for me.
Pero me tuve que rendir.
I had to surrender.
Y ese es el Getsemaní.
And that is your Getsemaní.
Señor, no se haga mi voluntad.
Lord, don't let your will be
hágase
not my will
tuya.
Be done, but yours.
Ese es el agua por la cintura.
And if the water comes up to your waist.
Cuando tú llegas a ese punto,
when you get to that level,
prepárate, hermano.
Be careful, brother.
Prepárate, pastor.
Get ready, pastor.
Prepárate, joven.
Get ready, young person.
Porque lo que viene después,
because what's coming after that,
son aguas que te van a tapar.
Are waters that are going to cover you.
Aguas que te van a bendecir.
Waters that are going to bless you.
A un nivel que no vas a poder hacer pie en el agua.
You can't
vas a tener que nadar.
You're going to have to swim.
En las bendiciones de Dios.
And the blessings of God.
Este es el avivamiento
que yo quiero.
This
is the revival that I've been
esto
seeking.
Esto es lo que yo estoy deseando
this
para la iglesia.
This is what I've been desiring.
Que Dios nos sorprenda en el nombre de Jesucristo con la gloria de Dios en medio de nosotros.
God in our midst.
Se puede lograr esto, hermano.
This can be achieved, brother.
Jesucristo dijo,
Jesus said,
el que cree en mí,
he who believes in me,
como dice la escritura,
as scripture says,
ríos,
rivers,
ríos,
rivers,
ríos,
rivers,
ríos de agua viva,
rivers of living water.
Alguien ayúdeme.
Someone help me.
Alguien quiero que lo grite.
Someone shout it with me.
Ríos,
rivers.
Come on, say it.
Dígalo.
Ríos,
rivers,
ríos de agua viva,
rivers of living water.
Come on, grítalo.
Shout it.
Ríos de agua viva,
rivers of living water.
Ríos de agua viva,
rivers of living water.
Van a empezar a correr por tu interior.
Going to begin to flow from your inside.
Yo no necesito ir a ningún lado.
I don't need to go anywhere else.
A sentir el poder de Dios.
To feel the power of God.
En mi iglesia no hay poder de Dios.
In my church there's no power.
Me voy
of God.
A la otra iglesia.
I'll go to the next church.
El poder no está en la iglesia.
The power of God isn't in that church.
Entiéndeme, hermano.
Understand me, brother.
El poder no está en la iglesia.
The power isn't in the church.
El poder está en el Espíritu Santo.
The power is in the Holy Spirit.
Y si usted tiene el Espíritu
and
Santo,
if you have the Holy Spirit,
usted tiene todo lo que necesita,
then you have everything that you need
para sentir el poder de
to
Dios
feel the power of God in your life.
Alguien levante sus manos al cielo.
Someone raise your hands to heaven.
Wow.
Hallelujah.
Let me. Quiero invitar a los pastores.
I'm going to ask the pastors.
Que se junten con sus jóvenes.
To come together with your youth.
Pastores.
Pastors.
Wherever you are.
Donde estén.
Come down.
Come.
Look for your young people.
Busquen a sus jóvenes. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Let me share this with you before.
Deja compartir esto contigo.
Déjame. Guys, I love you so much.
Los amo tanto, jóvenes.
I'm really proud of you.
Estoy tan orgulloso de ustedes.
But I want you to go to the next level,
pero
please.
Quiero que vayan al siguiente nivel, por favor.
I don't want people to push you to praise.
No quiero que la gente te empuje
para orar. Mom and dad to pray.
Que tu papá y mamá te empujen para orar.
I want you to do it by yourself.
Yo quiero que lo hagas tú solo.
I dedicated my life to the Lord when I was 13.
Yo dediqué mi vida al Señor cuando tenía 13 años.
I know that you can do it. I know that you can do it.
Yo sé que lo pueden hacer.
We need a generation right now, young people, that is seeking revival.
Necesitamos una generación que está buscando avivamiento.
Pastores,
pastors,
leaders,
líderes.
Quiero que entiendan que ya no estamos para tener cultitos.
I want to tell you that it's no more time to
ya, ya no estamos para tener cultitos.
We're not in a place to just have little services anymore.
Ya no estamos para repetir los mismos sermones todo el tiempo. Tenemos que entrar a otro nivel espiritual.
We have to enter in another level in the spirit.
Y saben que estos muchachos están desesperados.
And you know these young people, they're desperate.
Por entrar a otro nivel espiritual.
To enter into another level.
En el nombre de Jesucristo.
In the name of Jesus.
Y quiero terminar con esto.
And I want to finish with this.
El avivamiento viene.
Revival comes.
Listen to this.
Escuchen esto.
Listen to this.
Escuchen esto.
El avivamiento viene.
Revival comes.
Cuando tú te miras.
When you see yourself.
Como Dios te mira.
As God sees you.
Así como Dios te mira.
Just the way God sees you.
El avivamiento llega.
Revival comes.
Cuando uno busca el rostro de Dios,
when you seek the face of God,
y no las manos de Dios,
and not the hands of God.
Dame, 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 dame.
Give me, give me, give me.
Dame esto, dame. No, no, no.
Give me this and give me that.
Busca el rostro de Dios.
Seek the face of God.
El avivamiento viene.
Revival comes.
Cuando hay arrepentimiento.
When there's repentance.
Do you understand what I'm saying? You cannot worship here.
Escucha lo que le estoy diciendo. No, no puede tener esto aquí.
And have bitterness in your heart.
Si tienes amargura en tu corazón.
You cannot worship and hate your mom and dad.
Y tener odio con tu mamá y papá.
I don't care if he left you or your mom left you.
No importa,
it doesn't matter.
No importa.
God will never leave you.
Dios nunca te va a
nor
dejar.
Forsake you.
Dios nunca te va a desamparar.
And I'm
going
to finish with this.
Y voy a terminar con esto.
Y esto es para todos nosotros, hermanos.
And this is for all of us.
El avivamiento llegará a nuestra vida.
Revival comes.
Cuando de una vez por todas,
when once and for all,
entendamos que la audiencia, the audience, de todo lo que hacemos,
when the audience of everything we do,
es Dios,
is God.
Cuando usted entienda,
when you understand,
que la audiencia,
that the audience,
el que te está mirando,
the one that's watching,
when you play the guitar,
cuando toca la guitarra,
when you guys sing,
cuando cantan,
I know we have a lot of people here,
yo sé que hay mucha gente aquí,
but my audience,
pero la audiencia,
is God,
es Dios.
When you start thinking like this,
cuando piensan así,
everything you do is going to change,
todo va a cambiar.
Because sometimes, you know, the people will support us,
porque a veces la
sometimes
gente
they
apoyar,
don't,
y a veces no.
But you know, but when you think that God is the audience,
pero cuando entiendes que Dios es la audiencia,
everything that I do is for the glory of God.
Todo lo que hago es para Dios.
Everything that I'm doing right now is
todo
for
lo
His
que
glory.
Estoy diciendo es para Dios.
And I can imagine God,
y puedo imaginar a Dios,
hallelujah, looking at me,
mirándome,
smiling at me,
sonriendo,
enjoying what I'm doing. He is my audience.
Él es mi audiencia.
Y cuando usted entienda eso,
and when you understand this,
todo lo que tú hagas,
everything that you do,
va a cambiar por completo,
will change completely.
Porque vamos a satisfacer al Señor de la gloria.
Because we're going to satisfy the God of glory.
Put your hands up. Come on.
Levante sus manos.
Put your hands up.
Levante sus manos.
If you have the Holy Ghost,
si tienes el Espíritu Santo,
I want you to speak in tongues.
Quiero que hables en lenguas.
Come on, speak in tongues.
Habla en lenguas.
Yes! Shanda Rabahaya Maha!
Pour out your glory.
Woo!
Saturate them with your glory, O God.
Whoa! Holy Ghost!
Espíritu Santo!
Holy Ghost!
Espíritu Santo!
Holy Ghost!
Espíritu Santo!
I can do it!
Yo lo puedo hacer!
I cannot do it!
No lo puedo hacer!
I can't do it!
Si no es con Dios!
But you can!
Pero tú, Dios.
You can!
Él lo puede.
You can bring joy back to the church!
Lo puedes hacer, Dios.
You can bring back joy to my church!
Lo puede regresar a la iglesia.
My church is sad. We lost our pastor. We lost people.
Perdimos a gente.
But you can bring back joy to my church.
Pero puede regresar gozo a mi iglesia.
El velo que impedía tu presencia en mi vida se rompió. Yeah.
hazlo.
Si se humillare mi pueblo,
if my people would humble themselves,
sobre el cual mi nombre es invocado,
which are called by my name,
y oraren,
and pray,
y buscaren mi rostro,
and seek my face,
y se convirtieren de sus malos caminos,
and turn from their wicked ways,
entonces yo iré desde los cielos,
and will I hear from heaven,
y perdonaré su pecado,
and will forgive their sin,
y sanaré su tierra,
and will heal their land.
You can hide your sin.
Puedes esconder tu pecado.
You can leave this place hiding your sin.
Puedes salir de este lugar escondiendo tu pecado.
But I'm going to give you an alternative.
Pero te voy a dar una alternativa.
I'm going to give you an alternative.
Te voy a dar una alternativa.
You. I'm going to give you an alternative.
Te voy a dar una alternativa.
Why don't you repent?
¿Por qué no te arrepientas?
Why don't you ask God for forgiveness?
¿Por qué no te pides a Dios que te perdone?
Say, Lord, I'm sorry.
God, perdóname.
Perdóname, Señor.
Forgive me, Lord.
Yo no quiero salir de este lugar igual.
I don't want to leave this place the same way.
Yo quiero llegar a mi casa.
I want to get to my house.
Y quiero que entre el poder del Espíritu Santo.
And I want this power of the Holy Spirit.
Y si estás aquí, Padre.
And if you're here.
If you're here, Lord.
Si estás aquí, Señor.
Please.
Por favor.
Hear my prayer.
Escucha mi oración.
Put your hands up.
Levanta tus manos.
Talk to the Lord right now. I feel the anointing of God.
Puedo sentir la unción de Dios.
Hey, Amashan. Hermano pastor.
Pastor.
Si tus jóvenes están aquí.
If your young people are here.
Please.
Por favor.
Find them.
Encuéntrelos.
Go with them.
Ore con ellos.
Pray for them.
Ora por ellos.
Help them.
Ayúdalos.
Help them.
Ayúdalos.
To get inside this river.
Para meterse a este río.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Go with them.
Ve con ellos.
Go with them into the river.
Ve con ellos al río.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Estoy declarando.
I'm going to tell you something.
Estoy declarando un avivamiento.
A revival.
En la juventud de la asamblea
apostólica. The youth of the apostolic assembly.
En el nombre de Jesucristo.
In the name of Jesus.
No más al pecado.
You will not sin anymore.
No más al pecado.
No more to sin.
Voy a servir a Dios con todo mi corazón.
I'm going to serve God with all my heart.
Hikabashanda rabaha. The song. Wow. Come on!
just before the pandemic,
antes de la pandemia que comenzara,
this young man here, Walter,
este joven aquí, Walter,
who is a Pacific Islander,
que es un muchacho de las Islas de la Pacífica,
he came to my house knocking.
Él vino a mi casa.
He wanted to register me.
Él quería decirme
for what was it, the for the census.
Para el censo, quería preguntarme unas preguntas del censo.
And I told him, put your stuff down.
Dije, baja tus cosas.
Because I see ministry in you.
Porque miro ministerio en ti.
He looked at me.
Él me miró.
And he said, how did you know I was a Christian?
Dijo, ¿cómo sabías que era cristiano?
And I told him, I see ministry in you.
Dije, miro ministerio en ti.
And you belong here.
Y tú perteneces aquí.
At EPA Apostolic Church.
Y él vino a la iglesia apostólica.
He was a Methodist.
Era un metodista.
Minister.
Ministro en la iglesia metodista.
The Lord gave him the revelation.
Dios le dio la revelación.
Of who Jesus is.
De quién es Cristo.
Not two, not three.
No dos o tres.
But one.
Pero uno.
He was baptized in Jesus' name.
Él fue bautizado en el nombre de Jesucristo.
Came out of the water speaking in other tongues.
Y comenzó a hablar en otras lenguas.
I recently married him.
Lo inicié.
I married him to his wife Mele. Mele, would you live?
Lo casé con su esposa que está aquí.
Listen.
Escucha.
It's inside of the river.
Es dentro del río.
That the prophet said.
Que el profeta dijo.
That there are many fishes.
Que hay muchos pescados.
Inside of that river.
Dentro del río.
We don't fish with a rod.
Cachar un pescado con una caña.
We fish with a net.
Nosotros pescamos con redes.
And what the Holy Ghost is telling the Apostolic Assembly.
Y lo que el Espíritu Santo le está diciendo a la Asamblea Apostólica.
This revival.
Este avivamiento.
That Dr. Fortino.
Que el Dr. Fortino.
Has prophesied.
Está profetizando.
It is going to start.
Va a comenzar.
With the messengers of peace.
Con los mensajeros de paz.
You are going to go into that river.
Tú vas a entrar a ese río.
And you are going to get the big fishes.
Y vas a recibir los pescados grandes.
Listen.
Escucha.
He went back.
Él regresó
to the Methodist Church,
a la iglesia metodista,
baptized the pastor,
y habló con el pastor
of the Methodist Church,
de la iglesia metodista,
in the mighty name of Jesus.
Y ellos están siguiendo a Cristo.
Now listen.
Ahora escucha.
I'm going to ask you to raise your hands.
Te voy a pedir que levantes tus manos.
Because the Holy Ghost is here.
Para el Espíritu Santo que está aquí.
The Gospel of Mark says.
El Evangelio de Marcos nos dice.
Mark 16.
Marcos 16.
Verses 17 and 18.
Versículo 17 y 18.
And these signs.
Jesús dijo, y estas señales.
Will follow them that believe.
Seguirán aquellos que creen.
He said, in my name.
Dijo, en mi nombre.
You're going to cast out devils.
Tú vas a sacar demonios.
You're going to speak with new tongues.
Vas a hablar con lenguas nuevas.
If you drink any deadly thing,
y si comes cosa mortífera,
it's not going to hurt you.
No te hará daño.
But he also said,
pero también dijo,
they shall lay hands of Shatayamaka upon the sick,
pondrán manos sobre enfermos,
and the sick shall recover.
Los enfermos sanarán.
Listen, The gift of faith is in this place.
Escucha, hay fe en este lugar.
But the gift of working of miracles, it is also in this place.
El don de milagros está en este lugar.
I am going to release right now.
Yo voy a soltar ahorita.
The gift of faith.
El regalo de la fe.
And everywhere in this place.
Y todo lugar en esta área.
There are going to be healings.
Va a haber sanidades.
There are going to be miracles.
Va a haber prodigios.
Death. Ears are going to be open.
Oídos van a ser abiertos.
New organs are going to be formed.
Órganos van a ser formados.
Somebody's spinal cord is being healed right now.
La columna de alguien me está siendo sanada ahorita.
By the authority of the word of God.
Por la autoridad del nombre de Jesús.
And by the power that is in the name of Jesus.
Y el poder que está en el nombre de Jesús.
Shatayamaka. Receive,
recibe
your miracle,
el milagro,
in the mighty name of Jesus,
en el poder de Jesús.
Reciba su milagro,
receive your miracle,
en el nombre de Jesús,
in the name of Jesus.
Oídos sordos se han abiertos,
the deaf ears are open,
arterias se han abiertas,
arteries are open,
órganos nuevos se han formados.
New organs being formed.
Músculos.
Muscles.
Tendones.
That are being
huesos,
formed. Bones.
Se han formado.
That are being formed.
En el nombre de Jesús.
In the name of Jesus.
Este es el momento.
This is the moment.
Este es el lugar.
This is the place.
Reciba su milagro.
Receive your miracle.
En el nombre de Jesús.
In the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Gracias, Señor. Gracias. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for your word, God. Thank you for your presence. Thank you for your spirit. Thank you for your power, your love, your mercy. Bless the messengers of peace, God. Bless your people. Bless the apostolic assembly. Bless your church. Thank you, Jesus. Someone just say, thank you, Jesus. Come on, say, thank you, Lord. God is so good. What a beautiful spirit we feel in this place. Young people, church, as we prepare to dismiss, I have good news that as we dismiss from this arena, we are not dismissing from God's presence. I want you to take this revival that we have experienced today and the last few days home with you to your church, to your family, to your city, so that we all can have testimonies like we just heard a few moments ago. We're not just gonna win one by one. We're gonna take whole city blocks. We're gonna take neighborhoods. Does anybody believe that? We're gonna take communities. You're gonna take your campus, your junior high campus, your high school campus, your college campus. Revival's gonna break out. Someone shout revival. Amen. I want to thank God for allowing us to have this. How many of you are glad you came to National Youth Conference? I want to appreciate all of you who have come. I want to appreciate all of our pastors who have come, bishops and ministers, your wives and families. Thank you from the bottom of our hearts for coming and backing up the young people and supporting us financially, spiritually, in every way, physically. We love and appreciate. How many of you appreciate your pastor? Many of them are praying with you here at this altar or throughout this arena. We love you, pastors. Thank you so much. We're excited to work together with you. We're excited for what God has in store. And I have the task of bringing this to a close today. But we bless you in Jesus' name. I appreciate all of those who have helped put together this great event, working behind the scenes, our convention committee. I want to be careful not to start mentioning names because I will miss some of those names. You know who you are. I appreciate you. I appreciate all of our ushers. We have great ushers that have been so great. How many of you appreciate all of our ushers, our registration team? They've been working, running around, helping outside and so that you can enjoy being in here in the presence of God. Come on, let's appreciate them. Amen. Our production teams. Praise God, our musicians, our singers, our social media, and our creative team. We appreciate all of them. Praise God. And again, we appreciate our general board. We appreciate President Dr. John Fortino for that powerful message that we heard. this evening. How many of you appreciate that? Amen. God bless you. We're going to pray for him, his family. God bless Pastor Anthony Romo for that powerful word. Amen. That we also heard today. How many of you are just thankful for what God has done in this place? Amen. Right there we are. We're going to pray a prayer dismissal. Father, we come before you one more time. We thank you, God, for everything that has taken place. We thank you, God, because even in the children's ministry, they were receiving the Holy Ghost. Oh, thank you for our children ministry workers, God, our junior ministries out there, Lord. Thank you for the deaf ministry, Lord. Thank you for all that's been taking place this week, God. And thank you, God, for the way in which you moved here in this convention center, Lord. Now I pray, Lord, that you would bless each and every one of us as we move forward, as we arise, God. That you would take us wherever we go in all safety. You would encamp your angels around your people, Lord. I pray protection over your people right now. I pray this right now, God, as we dismiss from this place, but never, ever from your presence. We give you glory, we give you honor, in Jesus' name. Everyone say amen. God bless you. We're going to ask if you can help us to dismiss from here as promptly as you can. We don't have much time, so if you can help us at this time, do our ushers a favor. Let's work with them to exit the arena as promptly as we can. God bless you.